Ladies and gentlemen, regarding the business, hey, Bob Sanze, Okwenya Msoro, Okwenya Manza, Chimbotaura. Ladies and gentlemen, today's presentation is a little bit different from the presentations that I've done before. I think you can check the environment, the background environment of the presentation. But today I've got a serious issue that I need to talk about. That serious issue. Let me try to turn on the light, ladies and gentlemen. The light doesn't change much. The light doesn't change much, but let's talk, ladies and gentlemen. I've got quite a number of issues that I need to discuss with you. I've received a lot of I've received a lot of phone calls. I've received a lot of not just phone calls, messages from different people in the United Kingdom. I'm talking particularly of other Zimbabweans. We have got a lot of people who came from Zimbabwe who are in the United Kingdom. Some are in Scotland. When I say United Kingdom, I mean the four countries, Scotland, England, Welsh, and Northern Ireland. And some are in Southern Ireland, in that Dublin Island thing. Serious issue, very serious issue indeed, that I need to talk about the people of Zimbabwe, friends and relatives that have fled Zimbabwe. So I am appealing to those who fled Africa, who fled from other regions, not Africa alone, not Zimbabwe alone, from other regions, who went to different countries, Canada, America, United Kingdom, some are in Europe, everywhere in Europe. Shikai Mkomaobet, Alexander Ozamdara. So what I'm saying is, we've got a lot of people who left their countries of origin. I'm looking at things that a lot of people fled. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to dwell much on Zimbabwe as a country that I grew up in, where I was born. So if you talk about Zimbabwe today, it's a country that has suffered a lot ever since the country was colonized by the British people. A lot of bad things occurred. When they came to colonize Zimbabwe, they started introducing issues like taxes, that people were going to pay tax in Zimbabwe. The good part is the British collected that tax and managed to build Zimbabwe. They built towns, they put tar, they put electricity, they put everything. That was the purpose of the tax that they were collecting from the natives. So a lot of things happened during that era. Quite nasty things occurred where those who refused to pay tax, most of these guys were incarcerated. Most of them were hanged. So I'm looking at the uprisings, particularly that those initiated by the Charwes and a lot of people there who, as Apotagatera, they do not move scientists. So a lot of things happened, nasty things, where native people in the region ended up being hanged, some were imprisoned, some died unceremoniously. So it means the suffering of the people in that region, it began a long time ago. And those people, they moved from the colonizers into a government system which was introduced by Cecil John Rhodes and his people. So when they introduced that government system, they made sure there were police, there were prisons, there was army, there was this and that. A lot of institutions were created by the settlers. When they created, they went on to exchange power. Prime minister after prime minister, prime minister after prime minister. And the latest or the last prime minister that Zimbabweans are aware of, that they talk much about, was Ian Douglas Smith. Ian Douglas Smith became the last Rhodesian prime minister. And the region was named Rhodesia because of Rhodes. So it is perhaps the only African country in SADC or Southern Africa or Sub-Saharan Africa to have been named before a person. That country was like a private property to Cecil John Rhodes. It was named Rhodesia, named before Cecil John Rhodes. So you find that Rhodesia was a country that was named before a person, and it was something like a private property to Cecil John Rhodes, to the extent that Rhodes, who never stepped in that country, said, when I die, I want to be buried in Rhodesia. That was his territory. So Rhodes died. He was buried in Matopos. A lot of things happened after Rhodes' death. There was brutality of any kind in that region. The whites who dominated that government, they wanted to ensure they protect certain things which they said belonged to them. So Zimbabwe experienced oppression, or Zimbabweans or Rhodesians during that time, they experienced that oppression. But things changed. In 1980, when Zimbabweans gained independence, when the people of that region moved from Rhodesia to Zimbabwe, there was ululating, jubilations, people ululating, people going all over or overboard. You know, van vakafara during that time, that we have gained independence. We are going to run our lives. We are going to run our own country. We will convert the resources of the country into our own use. So we said we gained independence from the British government. Tabvisa varungu, taane mukana today of saying, oh, we are going to run our lives, we are going to rule ourselves. And you know that when you are running your own life, there is nowhere you can say, oh, I'm going to make this difficult for myself. Brandon, how are you? I'm going to make this difficult for myself. Nobody thought that. Say you the greetings. Webista, how are you, Baba Goredema? So nobody thought that one day we will have a black African oppressing blacks in our country, putting laws that make every Zimbabwean suffer. Nobody ever thought that. I was laughing when I was reading on a certain article, which said, do you know that Emmerson Dambudzo Mnangagwa, the current president in Zimbabwe, is a trained saboteur, someone who was trained to sabotage a country. And that person, a saboteur, is now the president of that country. And he doesn't even hesitate to put laws that will oppress Zimbabweans. He can sabotage anything. So the suffering that the people of Zimbabwe are enduring today could be a sabotage by all these Madaras. Because what they are saying is, you did not vote for us. So they are not even scared of sabotaging you. Leo, so you find that Zimbabweans today suffered a lot during Varungu's time. And the suffering continued after independence. What then happened? And the fake independence is the same as the Mbuyana and the fake. Thank you so much. So what happened to Zimbabweans after they suffered? Because during Ian Smith, when we suffered, a lot of Zimbabweans had no passports. What they did was to, they were cornered by Ian Smith. As a result, they came together, they started fighting Ian Smith until Ian Smith gave up. United Nations came. There was an election where the new oppressors said they won the election. ZANU-PF came and said, yes, we've won the election. And they established a government. Nobody ever thought that the ZANU-PF government will turn to be oppressors one day. If you listen to every video during that time, people were being asked, how about if Mugabe failed to deliver? And people were confident that Mugabe was going to deliver. But unfortunately, Mugabe failed. Instead of him stepping down, he turned himself into a dictator. You cannot say anything in Zimbabwe. You will be abducted and you will be murdered. This is why you see a lot of Zimbabweans, as a result, took passports and fled the country. That means we suffered oppression during the white people's rule. We suffered worse oppression during the black man's rule. And the results are that a lot of Zimbabweans, they fled Zimbabwe into different countries. Some of us, we are refugees in the United Kingdom. Some are refugees in America. Some are refugees in Canada. All over, Zimbabweans are scattered all over the world. The impact of them being all over the world is what we witness or what we see today. They are not only Zimbabweans. South Africans fled South Africa. Malawians fled Malawi. Burundians, Rwandans, DRC, Angola, Namibia, Botswana. People fleeing Africa into different parts of the world. Now, we've got a lot of Zimbabweans, a lot of Africans who fled to United Kingdom. Most of you are resident in England. Some are in Wales. Some are in Scotland. Some are in Northern Ireland. And Zimbabweans are scattered all over Europe. If you find when you arrive in these countries, for you to live there, for a foreigner to live in these countries, it has become very, very difficult. So what you need to do first, if you fled persecution from your country, the next thing when you land in the UK, you land everywhere in the world, Canada, America, the next thing is you go and seek asylum. When you seek asylum, you need to go through stages until they recognize you as a refugee. When you become a refugee, then this is when the governments of those countries will put you into their system to try and help you grow or adapt to your new environment. So some people, they fail to meet some requirements of those countries. And what do they become? They become undocumented. If you are denied asylum, you are not a refugee, then you become undocumented. When you become undocumented, you become illegal in this country, to the event that if the British catch up with you or arrest you, what they do is they detain you. After detaining you, they deport you to where you came from. And we know where we came from. Zimbabweans have never enjoyed life under the British, under the current government, to the extent that today, if you go to Zimbabwe, there are queues and queues of Zimbabweans looking for passports. And those Zimbabweans who are looking for passports, they want to leave the country. So we have got more people who are itching to run away from Zimbabwe today. A lot of people, if the Zimbabwe government give passports to every Zimbabwean in Zimbabwe today, everyone will flee that country. So if you flee Zimbabwe to go to anywhere in the world where you think you're going to start your life afresh, then in that country, you become a refugee. You become an asylum seeker, recognized refugee. If you are not a refugee, then you are an illegal immigrant. By being an illegal immigrant, that means you are an undocumented individual in that country who awaits deportation. Your life in any country is very uncertain. So this is what I am saying today, that Zimbabweans never enjoyed peace. They never enjoyed life. Zimbabweans never enjoyed peace. Zimbabweans never enjoyed life in their lifetime. Taibati wapfuti nevarungu. Tika vabati wapfuti nevarungu tairowa. Tichirini kwa minda. Kuitwa ma slaves in our own country. Takakura upenyo kuti waitu kwa ufunga. Kuti baba waru kushanda pa prazi. Avanacha wano kwansa kuitra mupenyo. But the government yevarungu chayanga yakanakira chinhu one. Vaitora mari, they used to take taxes. Votora mari, vovaka nzira. Ukatasa ma towns aripo today, I always tell people that the ZANU-PF government never built a town in 40 years. But these British people, the warungu, the whites, when they came to Zimbabwe, they built Harare. They want to build Mutare. They built Bulawayo. They built Gweru Kadoma, Kwekwe, Chegutu. They built Karoo Ichinoi. They built Mashingo. These were towns which were built from your taxes that they were collecting. And the result of refusing to pay tax saw a lot of people incarcerated. The hanging of Mbuyaneanda, although people say it was an uprising, it was this and that, she had refused to contribute to tax. So as a result, a lot of people died in the process. So this is why I'm saying Zimbabweans in particular, or Africans in particular, they never enjoyed life during that time. Because you need freedom. You need your rights respected if you are in a country or in your own country. We never enjoyed life in our own country. We went under black-to-black oppression. The initial oppression was white-to-black oppression, and we saw persecution. When it went from white-to-black oppression, it became black-to-black oppression. If you drive around today in Harare, you see black-to-black oppression. You see black-to-black oppression. Some people in Harare, the ministers, the president, the vice president, are building mansions. Mansions. If you drive around in Harare, there is no water. During the white people's rule, there was water in our taps. There was electricity. Today, there is load shedding. There is no electricity. Sewages are flowing every town. Sewages are flowing every location, every residential place in our black to black country, which has seen black to black oppression. If you talk that, look guys, Whatever you've done on black to black oppression, this is wrong. The next thing, you suffer abduction. We've got a lot of people who are abducted from their homes, who disappeared in our country. During white people rule, the likes of Edson Stolle disappeared. During black to black rule, with the likes of Rashiwe Gusha disappearing, with the likes of Marceline Zumbira disappearing, with the likes of Itai Dzamara disappearing. So you see, if you want to speak up, either you disappear in Zimbabwe, either you will be killed in Zimbabwe, your homestead will be destroyed in Zimbabwe. So the black to black oppression became the worst oppression that Zimbabweans ever suffered. We never thought that ZANU-PF government at one time would put laws and regulations that will oppress Zimbabweans. Today, Zimbabweans are suffering. They can't identify themselves as Zimbabweans. They have got no country. You travel all over the world, you meet a Zimbabwean. Go to Germany, you meet a Zimbabwean. Go to Poland, you meet a Zimbabwean. Go to Russia, you meet a Zimbabwean. Go to Belarus, you meet a Zimbabwean. Go to Argentina, Brazil, you meet a Zimbabwean. Most of these Zimbabweans, they have adopted citizenship from those countries, their host countries. So what I am saying here is we suffered during the white people. We are suffering during the black government. And we are suffering worse when we move from Zimbabwe to foreign countries. If you look at people in England, we've got asylum seekers here who have been in this country for the past 20 years. They haven't been granted asylum in this country. We have got refugees who have been in this country for so many years, whose rights are being trampled upon by the government. And we are suffering. Despite that, you have got refugee, you are an asylum seeker, you are an undocumented individual in this country. The suffering is the same. Ask refugees. We have got degrees in this country. Ask them what are they using those degrees for? You find an accountant with a degree in accounting in this country sweeping toilets. That person can't get a job in accounting because you are black. If you go, you do a degree in nursing. You don't see them in positions of influence. They are the piskers everywhere, doing the dirt work, blacks. Regardless that you have got qualifications that takes you to a better position, you will never use them as long as you are a black man. So you see, the suffering is continuing. Certain rights of Zimbabweans, certain rights of refugees, certain rights of asylum seekers, certain rights of undocumented people. People are suffering in this country. People are suffering in America. People are suffering in Canada. People are suffering in Australia. Because we are foreigners in that country. Our rights are not respected in those countries. Despite that, we eat. You drive any car you want. We eat, we drive any car that we want. You can afford to buy anything that you want. The biggest issue is about freedom. When you don't have freedom, then you are nothing. When you don't have peace, you are nothing. This is where this RRSG organization comes in. Because those asylum seekers, those refugees, those undocumented individuals, they have got their rights that the government should be honoring. The first right is the right to work. This is a right that they should be accorded. To say, okay, you're a failed asylum seeker. Yes, you are waiting a removal from this country. Yes, that's fine. But you should have a right to work in this country. You should have a right to work in England. You should have a right to work in Canada, Australia, America. In America, when you are if you are a failed asylum seeker, they keep you for 6 months. Then they will allow you to work. A failed asylum seeker in America will work. But in the UK, failed asylum seekers are not allowed to work. Undocumented people in this country, you cannot open a bank account. It is a right that those failed asylum seekers should have a bank account. Those asylum seekers, they should have access to care. Those asylum seekers should have access to accommodation. You need access to money to keep yourself going. Because if you don't have that money, then you won't survive. So what I am saying here is asylum seekers in other countries are allowed to work. Asylum seekers in this country are not allowed to work. We have got a lot of people suffering in this country. If you see some Zimbabweans, if you walk around, meet a lot of Zimbabweans who are undocumented. Look at the way he is dressing. Look at the way he has lost weight. Look at the way he doesn't have anywhere fixed abode where he lives. If found working, you'll be imprisoned. So all sorts of living have been taken away from you. You can't have a phone. You can't have a laptop. You can't have anything. If you are taken to present your cases before judges, some people can't simply talk. Most of them, they need legal advice. So you need legal advice. But as you understand, a lawyer cannot go and make a story for you. You need to tell a lawyer what happened to you, why you left Zimbabwe. We've got a very simple case here today. A very good example is about Solomon Makowero, who I used to call brother, socks, in South Africa. If you want to see that asylum seekers are in danger in Zimbabwe, a good example is about Solomon Makowero socks. Today, nobody knows where socks is. People suspect socks is in prison, Harare remand prison. Socks was arrested upon return to Zimbabwe. This makes Zimbabweans not safe in their country. Socks was a refugee in South Africa. Then he decided, okay, let me go home and be with other Zimbabweans. When he arrived in Zimbabwe, that same day, Socks was picked up by people with a car without a number plate. So this put the lives of Zimbabweans in danger. If you are an asylum seeker in the UK, if you are undocumented in this country, and if they want to deport or return you back home, this is where you find yourself in. You'll be arrested or you disappear. As I'm speaking, the government hasn't come open with what they did to Solomon Makowero. He was arrested in December at the Harare International Conference Center, where MDC Kupe were holding their conference. This is where Solomon Makowero was picked up after being sold out by certain elements in MDCT. Ladies and gentlemen, regardless of a crime that you have committed, both the first crime that Zimbabweans commit, let me tell you the truth. The first crime that Zimbabweans commit in the UK is coming to this country with fake passports. Most Zimbabweans went to Malawi and got Malawi passports. But they are not Malawians. I am a Malawi by descent, but never been in Malawi to get a passport. So the first crime that Zimbabweans do is travel to the UK with a faked passport. A Malawi passport, some came with a Botswana passport. Zimbabweans fleeing Zimbabwe with the different passports from different countries. That is the first crime that they commit. But the Home Office in the UK should consider why a Zimbabwean traveled to Malawi. Some of them never traveled there. They just bought it online, got that passport, bought a plane to the UK. If I wasn't fleeing anything in my country, I would simply go to registrar and obtain a passport, then travel to UK. But they saw it fit to say, look, I can't get a passport in Zimbabwe. If I go there, my life will be in danger. Choose to travel on a faked document to only try to flee Zimbabwe. And the problem is that not all asylum seekers or refugees are genuine. You help them when they get their visa, they become ZANU-PF in that same foreign land. Mkoma, thank you so much, Mkoma Webisagori. This is why I'm saying the Home Office in the UK, they need to work with people who really understand Zimbabweans. A lot of Zimbabweans, of course, they resorted back to ZANU-PF. If you ask them, they tell you this is our right, or else they just traveled to the UK to come and seek asylum using MDC name so that they can continue their evil doings. Most of them, they committed crimes in Zimbabwe as ZANU-PF people. But what I'm saying that if you are in the UK, there are certain rights that those failed asylum seekers must be accorded. Certain rights that those undocumented Zimbabweans must be accorded. Not Zimbabweans alone. We talk of Somalis, we talk of Ethiopians, we talk of Kenyans. There are Kenyans here. Burundians, Rwandese, Congolese. They are all here in this country. You understand? So if we look at those people, they need right to work. They need right to own bank accounts where if they work, they get their monies in. They need right to access health care. They need right to accommodation. As I've mentioned, if you meet some of our brothers and sisters from Zimbabwe, they are homeless because they are undocumented or they are failed asylum seekers. They've got nowhere to live, nothing to eat, nothing to wear at all. Wana boots inengeka pekwa. I had one guy from Zimbabwe. Let me pray. Can I ask Nakufa? Ana future in this country. So, ana kana nemani. Ndakatomirira akageza. Ndazomupereza unomusiya kugirlfriend yake. Pandakasvika kugirlfriend yake, ndakanzwa tsitsi. Unoziva kuti mfesiye mukadzi wake wandakaona naye pandakanomusiya pacho kunonzi kuAklam, kunonzi kuAklam. Muna haka shika shakata iso. Nduka kuzo msia mchaka peza mbuzi. kumachonyonyo uzandakatarisa mba macho so ndikati mwari ndakanzwa musodzi yangu kubuda ndo Brian what's the problem ndanzandira mapepa shamwari I'm not documented in this country I've got no option pamwe murungu endachata ndiwane mapepa andishande ndiye anondichengeta apo wakadhakwa andirimona zvinhu zvakandisiririsa ndakatanga kufunga I started focusing that look we suffered during the whites we are suffering during the black government we flee the country Zimbabwe into foreign land we come and suffer more in this country when are we going to have peace of mind when are we going to enjoy our lives I was thinking of the likes like Dr. Thomas Mapfumo Tafirenyika. If you look at the type of life Mkanya yaigara ku Zimbabwe, apana ndo rati Mkanya aitambura apana. He was driving any car of his choice, living imba yaigara, imba yakanaka. Varugara ku America vakatiza nyika yeZimbabwe. What crime did Thomas Mapfumo committed in Zimbabwe? Nothing. Kuimba kutaura kuti corruption yanyanya siyai corruption. Madima aita kuti nyika iite zvakanaka vachitaura vamapfumo. He became target of Zimbabwe government. We became targets of Zimbabwe government by telling them that please don't steal elections. If it is an election, why can't we have a free and fair election? Let me go and vote and choose a candidate of my choice. Rather than you grabbing a weapon and say, can you vote for a so-and-so? If you can, we are going to kill you. What happened? We fled Zimbabwe. We are refugees in this country. Pataka uya, apana izvandruke ndakupi. Apana izvandruke nogara kupi. We are still struggling to find somewhere to stand. So most of these issues, ladies and gentlemen, you can express them in a drama. You can express them here by talking so that the world know, the world understand. Though this is where an organization like RRSG comes in. This is a very good idea, a very good program. I've spoken to different people about this program where I found that these people can help you a lot. Some people got assistance. Auna laptop yekuti kuda kunyora zvada kunyora vamwe vakatengerwa ma laptop vanorashitaura nawo vakawanda vakati ah Shepard we never knew about this organization that is called RRSG which support asylum seekers, which support those people who are undocumented in this country, which support people who are disadvantaged in this country. There is an organization they call RRSG. I never knew about that organization until someone introduced me to it. This is when I went on their website. I looked on their website. I found a lot of things that people need to know. Zimbabweans, any asylum seeker in this country, any refugee in this country, anyone who is suffering in this country, RRSG is there to help you. They have encouraged a lot of people to do dramas. There are quite a lot of dramas that are there. I posted part of their work, the work that they do. It's so sad, Amidu, that we ran away. We ran away from our countries. And when we came to these countries, we thought we are going to enjoy life or we are going for safety. Little known that our friends or other people will end up suffering more than they suffered in Zimbabwe. Some have got nothing to eat. Some have got nowhere to sleep. Whilst they're in England, they're undocumented. They are not known. Vamwana kurwara vari muZimbabwe. Zvirwere zvisingataurika. Unozongonzwa kuti muZimbabwe akatwafa. Vamwe vacho they get pauper burial. Vamwe vacho munovaona pa social media vakudaidzirwa. Tine muZimbabwe akafa kwakati. Kana unoziva hama dzake, hapana anoziva hama dzake. Bozo mwakaya ni ma passport, ini kana ndichitiza Zimbabwe, ndo yeni passport ya kani shepa diudaka, mdoso, yukuma lao. Yino tonyo rwari mwezita. Ndaka seka, pataka buda mzimbabwe. Uno za hati ndichibuda mzimbabwe. Ndaka uza, ndichibuda mzimbabwe, ini nda asika nshepa diuda. When I left Zimbabwe, this is why you see, ZANU-PF struggled. Kuzo ndaka buda ni papi mzimbabwe. ZANU-PF struggled. The government struggled to really understand with pandaka buda na apo chaipo chaipo nde papi. Pandaka buda mZimbabwe nde papi. But up to now, even if you go to Zimbabwe, go to your borders, try to check with panere, paka nshepa duda, abuda mZimbabwe. Apana. To them, I was still in Zimbabwe. But I had left Zimbabwe. And ndaka buda nshepa duda. I'm not going to say because this is when you are running away. You have got no choice, but you need to flee for your life. We have suffered a lot. So I'm encouraging Zimbabweans. I'm encouraging So what I'm saying, I'm encouraging. What's your name, my brother? Mama Zimbabweans, if you ask some Zimbabweans here, particularly those who come from the western part of our country, you ask them, where do you come from? He will tell you, I come from South Africa. But if you speak to a South African, language, you can easily identify that this person is from South Africa and this is Zimbabwe. We know. Ukataura nem South African, you can tell that this guy is South African, it's not Zimbabwean. Well, if I talk to a Malawian, I'll tell you that this guy comes from Malawi. It doesn't sound Zimbabwean. So this was the problem with the Zimbabweans who came like with Malawi passports. When they came here, they speak to Malawi people, especially those people from Embas. Their type of English is different from the English that we speak in Zimbabwe. Vane kamwe ka kamwe ka mukati ka chigo. I mean, kamwe ka wanoshandisa kuti ukada kunzwa ka accent. Sorry, vane ka accent. Malawi people, if you talk to a Malawian who was born and bred in Malawi, who went to school in Malawi, ane ka accent. If you talk to a South African, he's got an accent in it. The accent, you can simply identify that this is America, and so forth. You can tell that this person is from South Africa. Red doors where asylum seekers live. Yes. It's very easy if you come like when I'm Middlesbrough. You can tell that they are asylum seekers because of their doors. When they are put there, the door is red. Then they are asylum seekers. You can easily identify that. So the problem is, people do not know where to get help. So I've come here with an idea. When I see RSG group, they've got things that they can help those undocumented asylum seekers, those people. Even if you are a refugee, I'm a refugee in this country. I still need help with a lot of things. It's not easy to adapt into the system, the British system, where you never grew up in. And the help is still required for me to say, I have to settle here. So if you find that the world we live in, it's a very difficult world. It's a world that you guys need to act. It's a world where we meet hostile environments as refugees. We meet hostile environments. As asylum seekers, we meet hostile environments. Kumabasa, chayako kumabasa, if you want to see the discrimination that we suffer because of the environment, it becomes a battle. There is a stronger battle than the battle we fought back home. We need Zimbabweans to understand, once you arrive in the UK, the battle starts. You need to be documented. You need to be an asylum seeker. You need to be a refugee. Even if you come to this country with a visa, 1 year working. When I came, I came with a working visa. When you come to this country, some people came with working visas. A good example is myself. I came with a working visa. But as a result, I found that even if I work for a year, 5 years in this country, and where will I go? Can I go back to Zimbabwe? No. So you find those type of battles. Zimbabweans are screaming silently. Zimbabweans are crying, or refugees, asylum seekers, undocumented people in this world. They scream silently. They need assistance, they need help. So the possibility of you getting help when you've got no knowledge, no idea where you can get that help from, this has brought us together, or today, to this presentation. Most people are waiting for brown envelopes. If you hear a knock when you are an undocumented person in a country, when you are a failed asylum seeker, if you hear a violent knock, the next thing you think is home office, and the next thing you think is about deportation, taken to holding centers, put leg irons, put handcuffs, taken to a plane, flown back to Zimbabwe, where you are likely to disappear. Today we are talking about Solomon Makovero, who disappeared. He was arrested in December. Until today, he's still in prison. And nobody knows where Solomon Makovero is. We are talking about Itai Dzamara. Almost 5 to 6 years, we are still crying. Where is Itai Dzamara? We are talking about Marceline Zumbira. We are talking about Rashwe Guja. All those are people who disappeared in Zimbabwe, under an independent Zimbabwe. When we reel or suffer under sanctions, the people quickly blame the opposition that it brought sanctions. They don't see our participation in DRC war that almost wiped our resources. They don't see all these disappearances in our country. We don't even feel for the families of those who disappeared in Zimbabwe. We don't even feel for the families of those who murdered for political reasons in Zimbabwe. But you are concerned about sanctions in your country. Say we are suffering. You don't care about someone's life, someone taken away in an independent Zimbabwe to disappear, someone who just disappeared. You don't get concerned. You don't feel for those people. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't know what type of people we want to become. Are we animals? Zimbabwe becomes a jungle where the rule of a jungle runs in the life. Shumba inongo mga ishungo bata membre chijika apana anu ibunza. Akuna anu isunga. Nzoga na boika na nongo donza shumba yokanda apa yotika tika apana anu isunga. Our country becomes a jungle where those weak animals like Shepherd Judah, they flee. Because if you stay, you'll be eaten in that country. There are organizations, ladies and gentlemen, that are willing to give you friendship. My organizations are good. Uda shamari here, uya uite shamari edu. So what I'm encouraging Zimbabweans is to engage with RRSG so that you tell your stories in a poetry. Those vanogona kunyora munonyora mapoems. Those talented to do dramas, you can do dramas. Short movies are available for you to watch, ladies and gentlemen. Tell your stories. Even if you go to a judge, let your video be played in court. Because Mazimbabweans mazhinji chandakaona, they don't really understand what evidence to take to court. Ukanzwa unachichema nenyako kanyatsomubvunzisisa, arikupa secondary evidence. Secondary evidence does not affect you. Ndosaka muchiona vazhinji vachirambirwa asylum claims avo kuma courts. Because unoenda nenyaya yekuti Shepherd Judah akarohwa akatiza. Saka ndikadzokera ndinorohwa ndikatiza. You should be producing primary evidence. So RRSG group, it will assist you with even solicitors. My asylum seekers and my refugees varipo. And that is how it's nyeper wawamwe. Uzaiwa, akusina legal aid. Mnenge musinga zivi. You are still entitled to legal aid if you are an asylum seeker. You are still entitled to that. The government of UK has created a link where you just pack in your postcode and they say, look, I need a lawyer to talk to about my asylum claim. And a list of lawyers will pop up. My lawyers are actually anima grades. Grade 1, grade 2, grade 3, grade 4. Aim to go for a grade 4 lawyer. Those with the money, you can get your own lawyers. But get advice from RRSG group. Vamwe havana pekugara, they've got no accommodation. Vamwe havana kana mari yekudya, they've got nothing to eat, no food. Mumwe havana kana nephone. Ndakatarisana nemwe blaze aiveka mbudzi ka phone. Kumutika phone akazvanza na zvekuita na mari. So there is help, ladies and gentlemen, for you. There is help for you. Help is there for you. Don't despair. You need help, and that help is available for you. The horror of leaving Zimbabwe, the panic of running away from home, a lot of things will collapse. The most painful thing, ladies and gentlemen, when I start talking about running away from home, leaving a country of birth, coming to seek refugee, coming to seek asylum in other countries, there are some things that people do not understand. There are some rights that you do not understand that you still have. For those rights, you need some people to engage, some people to talk to you. A lot of Zimbabweans, vana vekumusha vangu vanonzwa tsitsi, ndonzwa tsitsi, ndonzwa musodzi yangu buda pandosangana nevamwe. Ladies and gentlemen, ukaenda kunyika dzakaita sana Zimbabwe, there is no right to protest. You can't protest in Zimbabwe. Once you protest, you disappear. Vana Dr. Magombei vakano protesta. Vaka batwa. Vaka piswa mabora. Kwanza mabora Dr. Magombei anza hiti. Achiswa magets. Kushika wana chiremba wata achadi medical attention in this country. Because down below Dr. Magombei vaparara. Takaona achishushuruzwa Dr. Magombei. Achigadwa kwanza saradize vanhu zvombo zvapera zvatsva. Until his issue was debated in courts where he was allowed to seek medical attention elsewhere. And he left the country. Up to today, he can't talk. He's so scared. This is how much Zimbabweans have suffered under ZANU-PF government. Dr. Magombei can't talk. Can't come open. Can't tell people what he went through. Because he is still scared. If I am caught, I'll be done with. Freedom of expression. You can't get it in Zimbabwe. Those rights. Look at a very good example. Zimbabwe has got umbilical cord relationship with Belarus. And look at what Belarus has been doing recently to journalists. It has been arresting every journalist who talk about Belarus. And that oppression, that dictatorship is still going on. These are the countries that Zimbabwe want to associate with. They tell you for our economic survival, they associate with the dictators in Belarus. Ladies and gentlemen, this platform is going to air quite a lot of things. And the register to vote, comrade. Thanks, Mgoma Alex. Those who can register to vote are the people in Zimbabwe. We don't have right to vote. It's been withdrawn by ZANU-PF for fear that the people in the diaspora would speak. If you allow diaspora vote, we are going to speak. So we are failing to speak because we are not allowed to vote. There are certain individuals who vote in the ZANU-PF people in the UK vote. They go to Zimbabwe embassy and cast their votes, but they are not allowing every Zimbabwean to vote, right to vote. So we should be getting that freedom or right to vote as Zimbabweans. This platform will probably on daily basis air RRSG information. Things that you start to hear from this platform would probably come from RRSG where some dramas, encouragement of people to speak up. Theater is a very important mode of communication. Very important mode of communication. Some of us, I understand, the world we live in is a difficult world. But we must also boast a few idealistic things about theater. Some people think. Some people come up with ideas, and I am encouraging every Zimbabwean to participate in this. If you go online, just go and type rank and file. Then go through the rank and file people. They would tell you who they are, what they do. And this will be an interesting starting point for the people of Zimbabwe. So what I'm saying here, I'm encouraging asylum seekers to stand up. Whether you come from Asia, wherever you come from, Rwanda, anywhere in Africa, anywhere in the world. If you are in the UK, I'm encouraging you to join and stand up for yourself. This organization they call Reading Refugee Support Group. is there for you, is there for me, is there for every asylum seeker and documented individuals. If you ever know anyone who is undocumented, all those who are still seeking asylum, the refugees, there is an organization known as Reading Refugees Support Group, RRG. It's there to help you. It's there to help refugees. It's there to help asylum seekers. It has done that for over 25 years. Hanzi kwachenda mbuya havasi kuziva kuti people can register to vote. Zvisaishoko vazive. Thank you so much. Ndagumbu ndarwadziwa pandanzwa Zeki chitaura kuti the whole of May, only 6 people in Zimbabwe registered to vote. Zimbabweans do not know that this is their right to choose a government. A government that can save you. A government that can work for you. Voting is a very crucial right that every person should be engaging in. So the Reading Refugee Support Group helps refugee and asylum seekers to build their lives. It is everywhere in the UK. This organization started in 1994. It was started by a group of refugees who now provide services to hundreds of families and individuals across different towns in the UK. They support refugees from more than 50 countries who have escaped war, who has escaped violence, who have escaped persecution, and who have escaped modern slavery. I escaped violence. I escaped persecution. I escaped modern slavery. Reading Refugee Support Group will be there to support you. Whether you are documented refugee, undocumented individuals, asylum seekers, and refugees themselves. These people, they can support you. They can provide a space. They can give you practical support. They can support you with social activities. They run English lessons to those who want to really write like academic English. And they can assist you with accessing education. They've got volunteer people and they've got those employed to work for the organization. They empower the community so that you guys can access your rights. Some specialized services like health are also advocated for. And they campaign and raise awareness of issues of refugees. This is why I am saying, ladies and gentlemen, there is support for you. Don't suffer without you telling the world that you are suffering. Telling the untold stories of refugees. Telling the untold stories of asylum seekers and survivors of domestic abuse. This must inspire you to join in. Giving a voice to the voiceless and a platform to promote change. If you go on Rank and File website, you'll see everything that I've mentioned today. There are breaking news which you should be accessing. A lot of stories being told by refugees. What would a headline be? Stories that will break you down. So you need to join in, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to show you a video that I want you to go there. Let's see what's coming up. Hey, don't worry about the computer, Joe. Computer no shiba nai. Wow, no volume.
Their stories. It was partly to help them come to terms with often harrowing experiences, but the hope was also that their personal testimony might make us all rethink our attitude towards refugees. Well, videos of some of the powerful work they've produced are now being made available online, as Alan Sinclair reports.
I walked over 1,000 miles barefoot to get here. I'm tired and I'm hungry. For me, it's not about the statues.
These are the words of refugees and asylum seekers now living in Reading.
I saw my mother, my father, my sister, and my brother get killed by ISIS. I'm broken. For me, it's not about the statues.
This film and others have been created with the help of Reading Refugee Support Group. Dozens of asylum seekers join classes in person and online. The collaboration, a collective plea to not let their truth be drowned out by narrow perspectives, prejudice, or politics.
What makes this piece powerful? It's what I do my job for, and to have progressed over the last 20 weeks from looking at prose and poetry written by other writers or artists to then a participant speaking their own words, directly engaging with an audience, that to me is wonderful.
The project coincided with a growing awareness of past and present inequality, the Black Lives Matter movement demanding recognition and a reframing of our shared story.
One of my main hopes is that it will change the narrative that is there. At the moment, regarding how asylum seekers and refugees are portrayed, they are almost the cause of all the problems. Yet that's not the case. Don't turn your backs on me, please. I need help. For me, it's not about the statue. The people of the UK are brilliant. I'm privileged and honored to be living in Reading, and I'm sure a lot of asylum seekers feel very, very welcome in Reading.
Tabo's full film and others are available to watch on the Reading Culture Live website. Alan Sinclair, BBC South Today.
These are some of the issues, ladies and gentlemen, that will be aired on this platform. That will be aired on this platform to try and ensure that if you are a refugee in the UK, if you are an asylum seeker, if you are undocumented, you are not an animal, you've got a right to live a normal life. If they can't allow you to live here, at least they should give you right to work, right to education, right to health, and a lot of assistance will be rendered to you. So a lot of dramas will be aired on this platform, a lot of videos will be aired on this platform to raise awareness so that all those in the UK who haven't got the asylum, who haven't got, who are undocumented, and everybody who needs help is helped. When we talk of help, RRSG has supported a lot of people with food, clothes. Kunyangwe nemagetsi chaiwo kana akapera. Kana usina nhare yekuti unongochibatana nehama dzako, they can still assist you. Vamwe vamaona vanga vachitaura, they were given even my laptop chaiwo to make sure kuti they contact their relatives, vachitaura ma emails. A good example is about Shepherd Judah. When I came from Zimbabwe, I had no idea what a laptop is, how to turn it on, how to turn it off. I'm still learning more things on daily basis. And these people from Reading Refugee Support Group, they are striving to make life better. They can come to you and ask you, do you need a friend? This is a friend indeed. A friend indeed is a friend indeed. This is a friend in need. Those, they can assist you with your asylum cases. If you have got no friends, they can help you have friends. Food, clothing, accommodation, and a lot of things that these people can give you. They do this on a charity organization. It's like a charity to make sure that they help. There are certain people who feel that they need to help people. I've shown you a lady known as Judy here. She's just a volunteer who will try to assist you, who will try to help you. The horror of leaving our country. I would be interested if Mkoba Tabu can come and join me. I've got a friend, a colleague, a brother who can explain this much better than me. But what we need is help to make sure that everybody is helped. So I'm trying to bring a friend, a brother. You are still there. What we are talking today is a different topic. I'm trying to make sure that every asylum seeker, those who are documented and not documented refugees in this country, you get the help that you need. So this is what I am trying to do here. So there is an organization known as RISTG. That organization can assist you to make your life better. You are a human being. So we want to make your life better. Because if you look at Zimbabwe, ladies and gentlemen, people are not allowed to speak up. If you speak up, it's either you disappear from the world, they kill you. So we are lucky that we have got people who are willing, who volunteer in RRSG group to come teach you. We've got experts who have done this for the past 20 years and so forth, who volunteer to make sure that we are going to have dramas. The dramas coming up, which will benefit all the asylum seekers, refugees, undocumented people. So what I am saying is it's all up to you to come up open. You need help. We are here to try and assist you. Mkoma Henry Zwiri say, chirondirwadza about issue Zimbabwe. We have suffered a lot. We have suffered a lot. We have become freedom fighters where the freedom is elusive. Our country, a great Zimbabwe, a great country. It is a great country that needs you and me. So we are going to share a lot of things on this platform that will try to help our brothers and sisters. We are in the dark times as Zimbabweans. We are in the dark times as citizens of a world. We are operating in the dark times. We are singing in the dark times. What we are trying to tell those who turn blind eye to our suffering. Zimbabweans in particular have never enjoyed life in their country. We have suffered during the colonial rule. The suffering spilled into an independent Zimbabwe. We are still suffering in an independent Zimbabwe, to the extent that there are long queues in Zimbabwe where people are queuing for passports. If the Zimbabwe government today give every Zimbabwean a passport, you will never see anyone in that country. People are ready to flee Zimbabwe. Physical abuse, mental torture, physical torture. A lot of people have left that country. Similarly, other African states, Malawi, Botswana, Rwanda, Burundi, Tanzania, Kenya, Somalia, Ethiopia, Eritrea, everywhere, Egypt, Libya. Africa is a dark continent where Satan seems to flourish in that continent. The people we call leaders, they are heartless people that have seen thousands of people murdered, that have killed thousands and thousands of people in that country, in our Africa, our motherland, our continent, to the extent that a lot of people have left. Africa is facing this history of oppression. Africa, we are persecuted in our own countries. If we leave Africa, we leave our motherland, we come to the UK. Are we living large? No. In America, are you living large? No. In Canada, are you living large? No. We live under great oppression. We hope one day and one day only things will normalize. But when we will wake up from our deep slumber? Ladies and gentlemen, what do we need to do? I'm encouraging all refugees. I'm encouraging all asylum seekers. I'm encouraging all undocumented people to come open the Reading Refugee Support Group. Will assist you with your claims. If you have got nowhere to live, they can look into your issue. If you need something to eat, they are available as friends to give you something to eat. You can't live without food. You can't live with nothing to eat. You can't sleep in the open, on the open. United Kingdom is a very cold country where you need to live a human being life. Muri kunzwa here vakomana? Musachema shamwari yauya. Ndosaka mwana ndauya life nas kuti shamwari yauya. We've got a lot of people who have been helped by this organization. Pane ma short type drama anenge achiitwa. Regai nditangise video. Some of the beneficiaries of the RRSG group. Arts, theater, very important. A friend indeed, who can make you afford a smile. Ladies and gentlemen, there's going to be my presentations anenge achiitwa pano ekutrya kuti batsirane. Vanhu vari kuZimbabwe must know this. Nasi ndishepadi, an asylum seeker or a refugee in ndiwe. Saka sanogara waziva kuti ndikaenda kuBritain kana kuUK ndosvikira pakandichabatsirwa nevanhu vakati. This is very important. Because queue yandaona yevanhu varikuda mapassports haisi queue yevanhu varikuda kugara muZimbabwe. Haisi queue yevanhu varikuda kugara muZimbabwe. Iqueue yevanhu varikuda kubva muZimbabwe. Haisi queue yevanhu varikuda kugara muZimbabwe. When you are there queuing for a passport, the next thing is to think about your destination. Ndiri kuendepi? Hanzi kana uri England vakazvarwa before 1980, vakazvarwa uri muBritish, chitsvaga macase law anopedza nyaya yako, ndatopedza nemi. Hanzi kana uri muUK, vakazvarwa before independence, that means you were born in Commonwealth. You've got right to be in the UK. Saka hanzi tsvagaya macase law anoenderana nenyaya yako, rubatsiro ruri kubva kunani kune vanhu vamwe vanogona kutibatsira. Writings will try. I'm trying to aid my brother, but unfortunately, it's getting a mark here. On computer. I'm logged on a computer. So, drugs are matibatsirane vana veZimbabwe. Nekuti nyaya yatikutaura panapa inyaya inorwadza. Zimbabweans have suffered a lot. We have suffered during colonial rule. We thought independence will bring better lives for the people of Zimbabwe. Worse, we are now suffering more than what we suffered during the colonial rule. We fled Zimbabwe, come to foreign land where we thought life gonna be rose. But we are suffering more than what we suffered in our countries. A good example, ini ndakataurira a good example is myself, guys. I've been through a lot in Zimbabwe. I've suffered a lot in Zimbabwe. When I came to the UK, I thought ndauya kuzogara pasi ndinyatso zorora pfungwa, ndizorodze pfungwa. But the struggle continues in this country. The struggle continues. And I don't know where this will end. Will I ever enjoy life in my lifetime? Freedom is like elusive in this country. No, which will drive a motor car? Because you are a black man. Especially if you come to Cleveland, Middlesbrough. This is a place where racists live in UK. Kana wakambonzwa upenyu wemu United Kingdom, kana kuziva kuti nzvimbo ine ma racists nzvimbo ipi. Because we've got few blacks in this area. So the police here are not as friendly as the police in London. The police in Middlesbrough are not as friendly as the police in Manchester. The police in Middlesbrough are not as friendly as the police in Leeds. I've never been stopped in Leeds. Never been stopped by police in Leeds. But here in Middlesbrough, I was stopped on numerous occasions. I still remember one incident when I was stopped by police. I went to a filling station because I was going to work early in the morning. I was teaching at a secondary school in Redcar. So when I came from work, I said, no, I've run out of fuel. I need to refuel my car. So I had to take at least a few minutes to rest at home, then proceeded to a filling station. When I got to the filling station, I filled in my car with the fuel. I paid. When I was walking away from the pump going into the shop, I saw a police BMW parking beside my car like this. I saw them. So I paid. When I was walking out of the shop, they drove away. When they drove away, they went to a shop, Tesco's. There's Tesco's, a very big Tesco's there. Then they turned and put their car nose on the road. So when I was driving from the filling station, I could tell that that car is a BMW, a police car. So I went into a roundabout. When I was getting out of that roundabout, that car started following me. I could tell from the rear view mirror that there is a police car following me. So I drove for almost 3 miles. When I was about to turn into a road that goes to my place, they started flashing to indicate that I should stop. I did not stop right there because I never thought that they were following me. I knew that these people are following me, but for what reason would the police follow me? Then I turned. When I turned, the police van, the police car, it turned following me. I was about 100 meters away from home. Then I found a safe place to park my car. I indicated, I stopped. 2 police officers came. When they came, you know what they asked me? A very stupid question. The first question that they asked me is, have you been drinking? You know, it's sort of like an insult to someone who never took alcohol, to someone who doesn't smoke. I don't drink, I don't smoke. But this is stupid policeman had to ask me, have you been drinking? I asked him, what do you mean? He said, because when we were following you, you were driving in a zigzag manner. I said, really? I was driving in a zigzag manner. He said, yes. Then I said, how many miles did I drive like that? He said, about 3 miles. Then I said, I asked him a very silly question, a very simple question. Are you a qualified policeman? Then he said, yes. You saw me driving erratically or in a zigzag manner as you explain. He said, yes. Then I said, why didn't you stop me right there when you started seeing that I was driving erratically? You let me drive for 3 miles. You never stopped me. And you just stopped me after 3 miles. Then you want me to believe that you're a qualified policeman. How about if I was like someone who got attacked or heart attack or anything and that car was zigzagging? So you are lying. I told the policeman that you are lying. You were not sure whether I'm black or white. But when I indicated to turn, your lights flashed at me and saw that this car is being driven by a black man. And you just felt we have to make him miserable. You stopped me because I'm just black. Because you cannot stop me and ask me a stupid question. That have you been drinking? I told you I don't drink. I don't smoke. And you believed me. You never even attempted to put me on breathalyzer to see if I wasn't drunk. What type of a policeman are you? So I told him, because you are racist, I said, bugler off. So I wanted to start my car and drive away. He snatched my car keys. I didn't get out of the car. He just got in, snatched my car keys. Then I asked the policeman, why are you taking my keys away? You stopped me for no apparent reason. I told you I don't smoke. I don't drink. So why did you stop me? He was like bees now on his radio. I said, you are bad apples in the police. This is why Cleveland police is labeled the most corrupt force in the UK. You are the most racist force in the United Kingdom. You just feel that one is a black man. We can do whatever we want with him. Then you stopped him. So I got off, snatched my keys back, got into the car, started my car, locked my doors, and drove away. They followed me. I indicated I parked my car at home, locked my car, got in my house. I could see them through the window. They were like going around my car now for no apparent reason, because you're a black man. All that suffering, harassment, to me it was a police harassment. Police were harassing me for no apparent reason, for no crime committed. The other day I was driving, going to work. When I was driving, there was about 50 mile an hour speed limit. So I was driving at 45 miles an hour. When I saw a sign indicating that you should go on national speed limit, I accelerated from 45 to 65 miles an hour. And there was a police car behind me. It started flashing its lights following me. He stopped me. The guy who stopped me had 2 stars to show that he was a commissioner. When he stopped me, he asked me a very silly question. Can I have a look at your shoe? I said, my shoe? The one that I'm wearing. He said, I was wearing a suit. As a teacher, I was going to teach, wearing a suit to be like a role model in front of students. Frost, how are you? So I opened my door. I had a very nice shoe. I showed him the shoe that I was wearing. Then I closed my door. I was wearing on a nice navy blue suit. And he asked me a stupid question. I asked him, why did you stop me? I'm going to work. You are delaying me. He said, whose car is this? A very stupid question from a policeman. Then I told him, when he stopped me, what did your dashboard, your sensor, told you? That whose car is this? Do you mean I can't afford to buy this car? Is it where you want to ask? He said, it's my car, it's my car. Then he asked me, what's your name? I told him, I'm Shepherd Yuda. I produced my driver's license I gave him. Then he said, he was on his radio again, confirming if that car was insured. He looked underneath my car, went around my car for no apparent reason. Then I asked him, why did you stop me? It was a silly, stupid answer. Then I told him, fuck off. So I'm sorry for that language, but that's what I told him. I told him, fuck off. Got my license back, started my car, then I drove off. I left him standing there because totally there was no reason for him to stop me. And I was a bit late at work. So this is the suffering that we find ourselves in. That guy just thought, this guy is a black man, let me just stop him. And he stopped me. That was not the only second incident. A lot of incidents followed later on. The other one, I was stopped coming from church wearing a white gown. A van full of police from Cleveland followed me all the way when I was dropping someone in Misbra. They came, you know, I could tell some of them were armed. For no apparent reason. And they asked me the same silly question. Whose car is that? My car. What's wrong with it? So you find out that that type of oppression, we suffer in foreign countries because of our skin. But these people don't understand us. So we suffer. We suffered during colonial rule. We suffered in our own country, as Zimbabwe. The good part of British police, they don't torture you. Unlike in Zimbabwe. When they stop in Zimbabwe, you make sure you get a slap, you get a shambok, you get something painful that they inflict on you. That's one of Jera's, I think that's their problem. Because the guy who stopped me when I was going to work, he asked me, my friend, I know you are driving a powerful machine. The way you accelerated from there to there, I said, what's the problem with it? I was driving at 45 miles an hour, accelerated to 65 miles an hour, and you stopped me. Why did you stop me? Can I go to your dashboard right now and see how much I was going at? I know. I said, so why did you stop me? Why? Stupid, man. I said, fuck off to him. And I started my car, boom, then drove off. I left him standing there with his car flashing those lights. The most corrupt force in England is the Cleveland police. And they are the most police that they don't know what they do. They don't know. Last time I went to London. I've never been stopped in London. Never been stopped in Southend or Sea, Portsmouth, everywhere. Manchester, Birmingham. I've never been stopped by police. But Cleveland police, they just stop you because you are black. And they've got no, they say nothing to you. They say nothing to you. When I went to London, I didn't know that when you are driving in London, you need to pay congestion fee, you need to pay emission fee. So they followed the bailiffs, they wanted to collect emission fee and the congestion fee. So when the bailiff came here, I told the bailiff, look, I'm going to pay. I didn't know, I had no idea. It's not my first time going to London. I've been in London so many times driving around London. I never got those charges. He said, no, you need to pay. I said, okay, fine, I'm going to pay. He said, no, I need the money now. I said, no, man, I don't have the money now. If you want to take me to court, then I'll go tell the court. I can pay you so much a month. So the guy said, oh, if you don't have the money, I'm going to tow your vehicle. He wanted to stamp my X5. I told him, no. You are a bailiff. They've been sent to collect this money. You've got no right to tow my car. You can take any other property that does not help the family. Because this car is the car that I used to go to work, the car that I take my kids to school. You can't tow that car. You can take anything if you want. Because you do not understand what I'm telling you. So when I was preventing him from clamping my vehicle, he called the police. 2 minutes, 8 policemen landed at my house. 8 policemen landed at my house. I then asked them. When they came, they went straight to my car, took my car keys and gave them to a bailiff. I asked the police, I've got the video, I'll post it one day, when I was challenging them to say, you are supposed to be people protecting crimes in this country. But you are coming to take sides of a bailiff because he's white. There is no criminal matter here. It's a civil matter that I can settle with the bailiff in court. And I don't know why you are taking my khakis. For what reason? 8 of the policemen, when I was talking to them, I think someone or their boss was listening to what I was telling them. Because I was challenging them with law. I was challenging them with the facts. And I told the bailiff that, my friend, you are lucky. I could have melted your balls with a kick. You're very lucky. I'll post the video here. And one of the policemen, I think he was about 16 or 18 years of age, I clearly told him that these police duties are not your cup of tea, man. At your age, you should be in school. You should go and start. Because whatever you are doing, you don't really understand your police duties. Your police duty. This is not a criminal matter. It's a civil matter that I can settle with the bailiff in court. Not at a police station. If the court they approached wanted the police to be involved, they were going to give you the summon or whatever, you could have come, not the bailiff. But the courts understand the law. They don't want you to get involved. They want the bailiff who went to get an order there, not you. So can you buggle off my property? You understand? So you find, because we are blacks, and the Cleveland police thought, we can do whatever we want because he's a black man. So I had to challenge them lawfully with the facts. At the end, I saw 3 of the 4 vehicles which had come leaving my premises, my property. So this is why the suffering that we go through is refugees in this country. What the police will try to force you to do is try to fight them so that they can say, it's violent and this and that. They lock you up and say you are violent. What they are fighting for is to criminalize every black person in the UK. So this is where we say the suffering that Zimbabweans went through during colonial era, during Zimbabwe government era, and now, we are still suffering. Whether we left our country, we have got no peace in foreign land. So this is why I'm calling all refugees in this country, all asylum seekers in this country, and those undocumented people in this country, to say, please, there is RRSG. Join that organization. It can help you. It can help you with anything that you think. Because you need to work. Despite that you are undocumented, the government has to document you. The government has to make sure that you have got accommodation, you eat. Because once you are here, obvious. You might be illegal, but you are an asylum seeker. So get documented. Get into the system. This organization will assist you. You should be getting money to eat, accommodation. A lot of people back home, they think, there's shortage of accommodation in the UK. Because they see us sleeping elsewhere. There are people back home who are expecting you to help them. Little known that you can't. The problems that you are facing in the UK are serious problems. You understand? So, the United Kingdom as a government is a signatory to international covenant on economic, social, and cultural rights. We suffer now in the United Kingdom because we don't know that we have rights as asylum seekers, that we don't have rights, that we have rights as refugees, that we have rights even if you are undocumented. So too is Zimbabwe. So too is Mozambique. So too is South Africa and Botswana. Even if you are in Botswana, you have got rights. Those Zimbabweans in South Africa, they've got rights. This is why you see those Mozambicans who fled Mozambique war coming to Zimbabwe. They are paid in US dollars. If you go to South Africa, they must be paid, those refugees must be paid in US dollars. If you go to Tongogara Camp, where the Somalis and so forth in Chipinge were housed, every week or every month, they were receiving payments in US dollar. So, we are saying, an organization known as RRSG is there to help you guys. Whether you are a refugee, asylum seeker, undocumented individual in this country, whether you're from Zimbabwe, Somalia, everywhere, you've got rights, certain rights that are bestowed in you by this covenant. It's an international covenant on economic, social, and cultural rights, where you are recognized as a human being with certain rights, and you should eat. If you look at asylum seekers in America, just 6 months down the line, they will allow you to work. You open a bank account. You have got access to healthcare. You've got a lot of access to things, accommodation and everything. So this is why we are saying it's time to work with organizations like RRSG to help you and me help ourselves to human life, easy life. Those who require lawyers, there is a link, I'll probably post it tomorrow. A link where you can just pack in your postcode and it directs you to legal aid lawyers. If you can afford your own lawyer, there's no problem. But there are lawyers who can assist you with your asylum claims. Those who need asylum issues to be solved. If you can pay your own lawyer, that's fine. But if you need a lawyer to urgently apply for your asylum or to deal with your matter, I'll post the link tomorrow. And really understand what type of lawyer you are going to engage. Because a lot of people do not understand or they do not know how to do it. And RRSG will assist you, especially when they can teach you even how to present your evidence in court, how to talk confidentially. But some people, they just lose matters, lose cases, but they are not confident in presenting their facts or writing. They can assist you to go back to school. Those want to go to colleges, some are going to universities, and so forth. So a lot of things are there for your assistance, ladies and gentlemen. Don't suffer silently. Don't scream silently when the help is accessible. Ladies and gentlemen, I know by the end of this presentation, a lot of people flood my inbox. Don't hesitate to flood my inbox. Don't hesitate. Usanyara kutanza ndina mapepa. Andisi documented mu UK. Zvaita sei. Please don't hesitate. This is your life. You only live once. You need to live a peaceful life, a prosperous life. You have suffered under colonial rule. You have suffered under black government. And you can't suffer when you fled that black oppression to come to the UK, to come and have peace of mind. Tiri kutambura vana vamwari. Asinofanira kutibatsirane tione kuti what are we, what can we do? How can we do it? Why are we suffering? Do we need to continue to suffer in that matter? Zimbabweans, we've suffered a lot, and we must bid farewell to our suffering. Pane vanhu varipo vane mweya waMwari wekuda kukubatsirai. Ngatishande nevanhu vanoda kutibatsira. Andidi manzwa nyaya ndikutaura. Panama different cases which you are going to see on this platform, which are going to open your mind, open your eyes. Ladies and gentlemen, kana pane vanenge vachida kubvunza munoya inbox kwangu totaurirana kuti zvofamba sei vanobatsirikana vobatsirikana. Ndakambotaura kuna vamwe vanhu ndikati I might be a link between God and yourself. I might be a link between it. If you feel like you need help, don't hesitate. Hit my inbox to batsirana. Andedi. Saka ndonya iripo vana vamwari. Mukada tichitaura kuti vana vamwari ndikureva imimi vana vamwari musazotevera maprofita akaita sana Twabani. Pane evidence dzazobuda dzekuti tazonyara. Kune vamwe vairamba vachiti hasi ndiye, but being gay ma rights ake. We must not attack him for being gay. We now know that the boy is gay, but don't attack him for being gay. These are his rights. Nobody attacks you for being a straight. You understand? Sexual preference must never be something that people will attack you with. Saka, let's not attack one another on sexual preferences. Ladies and gentlemen, zvakawanda zvekuti kada kutaura pano hatingapedzi. Handiri maona. Saka nyaya yati kutaura iri kutaurwa nevamwe vazhinji vataura kuti go register and vote. Zeki iri kutaura kuti for the past last month, Zeki iri kutaura iyo kuti only 6 people register to vote in Zimbabwe. That means you guys are not ready to free yourselves. You are not ready to make sure that your life become easy. Hanzi makuzvinyanya nanoma, that's not him. Pazobuda imwe information. Hanzi mukoma Yuda muri sei ndanonoka. Munenge mune nyaya yakanaka nhasi. Nyaya ndina yakanaka atete Barbara. Inyaya yevanhu vari muno muUK, especially all over the world anyway. Vanoda assistance, especially my asylum seekers, my undocumented individuals, nema refugees, vanoda assistance. Tine group, kune group runonzi ara reading, runonzi ara RSG, regaini kutaura in short. That group runobatsirana nevanhu vanoda help. Hakuna munhu anofanirwa kurara panze. Kana uri uchinzi uri failed asylum seeker, pane marights aripo ekuti unogona kushanda, but those rights kana vanhu vasingazive, you cannot explore them. So you must be allowed to work, open up a bank account, have food, have accommodation, and do a lot of things. Kana pane vanenge vachifeel out they need help, we just link them nema organizations akadaro. Zvadaro pane ma RSG ine ma volunteers, ine ma workers ayo who are doing ma, for some people who are doing like ma drama and so forth. But some people, they can fail to talk in court, but they can express themselves in a poem, in a drama, in anything that can be used in court to say, look, this is exactly what this person wanted to say, but cannot say it in a court of law. So, zvinenge zviripo pakubatsirana. Hanzi, but it's against God's plan. Hanzi, but it's against God's plan. God's plan, mukoma Victor, regaini botaura, ndokara kuda kudzisa vanhu inini. Isusu tiri vanhu venyama, mukoma Victor. Kana tiri vanhu venyama, let's not go in front of God. Let God speak. Because isusu tikazviita vana Mwari, tinge takanganisa. Ndokara chitaura kuti vanhu vazhinji tinomhanyira kuti God. Ukaenda kuZimbabwe, tine maprofita akawanda. Probably half of Zimbabwe population is full of prophets. And those prophets, imagine, not even one prophet managed to identify where Malaysian plane went to. Out of that world of prophets, up to today, no one identified where Itai Dzamara is. Out of all those prophets who believe in God, who talk to God on daily basis, not even one of them managed to indicate where Musoro Watapiwa is. And in the morning, Saka, we become very suspicious of people who use God's name. That if you are true prophets of God, you talk to God, please just indicate to us where a Malaysian plane went. Ndege yese makuragata ndege isonoka yakarasika apana kana wana ari kukwasa zvava kuti ndege iyo nevanhu 250 vanhu vari mundege zvakaendepi. The whole world, my satellite dish, everything failed to see that ndege. Saka vanhu vanotaura namwari kana vaakutadza kuti kuziva kuti ndege yakaendepi vachitaura namwari every day. Ndimi vanhu vatinge taakubata pahuro kuti don't lie to us. And vanhu vacho vataura namwari ivava ndovanenge vachiti gayism is against God. But behind closed doors ndovanenge ari magei acho. Takaona zvakawanda isusu. Indakati Mwari vakandiitira zvakanaka. Nokuti zvimwe zvacho ndakazviona nemaziso angu. Zvimwe ndainzwa nenzeve dzangu. MuZimbabwe maive napuresident ainzi Kanani Sodindo Banana. Aive nemukadzi. Ndara yanga aitosiya mukadzi kumba uko. Achinorakasha vana Jefta Dwe. Varume. Vafana vaitamba bhora Tornadoes. Vana vechikoro pauniversity. Mauniversity students enyu amunoona kana magweta atanawo mazhinji aya. Vafana vakadzidza nguva dzaKanani Banana. Vazhinji vacho ese vakaita vakadzi nabanana. But vazhinji vacho they did not come open. Mundarayo was like, I lula. Ichirume mundarayo. Saka kune vanhu vakawanda vatakataura kuti Zimbabwe government, why do you attack gays when gayism was being practiced in state house? Yamunoti state house yenyu nhasi. Chigei chakatanga nezanu pf. And chinoitwa muzanu pf. Saka ndichigara chitaurira vanhu kuti, let's not attack them. Because by me attacking them, tiri kutoda violate my rights avo. Bhosi kati Mwari vakazviramba, hapana anogona kuzviprova kuti Mwari vakazviramba. Kuenda nemamachechi havaverenge Bhaibheri. Vabanana vakati Bhaibheri roda kuti nyorwa rewriting, bhosi zvinhu zvirimo kunyepa. Handidi maona. Saka pane people have got certain rights. Let's not kuti isusu inini zvandisingade kana ndoti inini ndirimu yavo. Handidyi nguruve. Ndobvandati munhu wese ari muZimbabwe usadya nguruve nekuti handidye nguruve. Ndaiseka rimwe day. Ndaiseka rimwe day so. Day iroro. Ndakaenda kumasowe. Ndasvika kumasowe. Ndobva vanhu vakuti takanzi mutero yakazoti zvakati. Mutero yakazoti zvakati. Ndobva kwazosimuka vamwe baba zvikanzi imi varume imi. Musangoti muteure muchikotaura zvimangamanga panapa. Zvikanzi ngirozi padzaiuya madhara aya vane zvavaibata-bata. Saka ngirozi dzaikuisai pamuteuro. Munhu anonga aiswa pamuteuro kunzi china udye nyama iwewe. Iwo bva wataura kuti nondaidzinini nengirozi china handidye nyama. Waakutora muteuro wako iwewo. Waakuita muteuro wegungano remachechi waakuti pasi rese musadye nyama china nekuti Mwari vakaramba kuti tidye nyama. Ari munhu wani akaiswa pamuteuro wenyama. Andoro. Saka zvinonetsa kuti titi Mwari chisamwari pamwe paasingapinde ndodzimwe mhaka mhosva dzatotora pana Mwari. Ukatarisa information yanga ichisekulata iyai. Ukada kutoitarisa yatya banhu. Kana uri ndiwo unogona kumurambira kuti haasi. Vamwe kuti haasi. Kuti tatu rinobva rauya apa. Wobva waita kati yakaita sastwapani. Wobva waita look alike. Imi musade kuti vhara kanai. Imbomirai kuti nyepera. Zvatiri kuona. Handimona. pane zvinhu zvakawanda zvekuti zvatinoita zviri worse than pamwe kuda zvinoitwa nemagei acho. Clive Simbodi andiri papendenisi. Uri pamusha pangu wena mwana wamai. Papendenisi paya uri pamusha pangu. Tichataura. Tichataura. Unouya kuinbox kwangu tokurukura. Uri pamusha pangu. Andimona. Saka tingachidzidzisana. Guys, mbodzidzai. Nyika yeZimbabwe inyika yakatambura zvikuru. Takatanga kutambudzwa nevauyi vaibva kune nyika dzavo. Vakasvika vakatanga kusa mutemo. Asi mitemo yacho imwe yacho yanga yakanakira isusu vanhu vatema. Nenyaya yekuti vana Rhodes pavakauya vakatanga kuorganizai kuti itai macommunities. Maita macommunities munounganidza mari. Mopfaga munhu wano wamuchati ndiye anotitungamirira community yedu yese. Oita president. Aita president anenge achiona mari dzamunobvisa. Ndiye anenge akutorawo kuti iwe uchiona zvogadzirwa kweroad. Iwe uchiona zvogadzirwa kwezvekucherwa kwemigodhi. Iwe uchiona izvi neizvi neizvi. So at the end, they managed to create my towns. Vana Harare, vana Mutare, vana Bulawayo. Vakagadzira road to link those my towns. Vachiti already Bulawayo chisona iboots. Yaira dzomuchitengesa kuHarare. KuHarare bikai izvakati. Hanzi town yechivhu. Gosh darar. KuHarare bikai maspageti tengesai kuBulawayo. KwaMutare rimai makabhichi naimotengesa kuBulawayo. Makutointrodza chinhu chinonzi economy. Chaakurwadza zuva ranhasi. Ndechekuti zvakasiyiwa zvaitwa setup nemabhunu. Takati vari kuti dzvanyirira. Ndobva tadai wagatirova neinavo vanhu avo. Tikapinda musango tikarwa hondo yakaoma. Hondo ikapera. Vanhu vakatanga kuimba Zimbabwe yauya. Ukaona teererai mumhanzi yaiimbwa nana Mudhara Mapfumo. Yaiimbwa nana Job Mashanda. Yaiimbwa 1980. Hanzani PF izere ngochani shuwa. Remember the constitution is not clear on gays and lesbians. It only speaks of gay marriage not allowed but silent on relationship. Vakatoisa vakatozviitira peposi vana Jonathan Moyo. Bozi ndovakanga vari madhara acho vana sodindu. Andiri bona. So 1980 pakatanga kuimbwa munziyo dzakasiyana siyana dzekuya kweindependence. Pane vanhu vaifamba munyika medu. Vachibvunza majournalists vaibvunza varungu vakataura kuti government nyowani yauya is stinking zvikandaona nyika inoya parara vanhu vakati bhunu ropenga vanhu vakainterviewa vakataura vakati aiwa vamugaba handione vachitadza kuzotipa ndodati murume wangu ahore mari yakakwana yekuti anokwanisa kutenga imba. Anokwanisa kuendesa vana kuchikoro todya tichiguta pano pamba. Ndoza zvakatarisirwa neruzhinji rwevanhu. Pakainterviewa vanhu vakasiyana siyana vachipa ma different views. Smith akataura kati ndikasiya nyika inoyi kuitonga ndaona vanhu vatema vanwa sewage munyika muno. Vanhu vakati Smith unopenga. Nhasi unoyu taakumira kutarisa. Those interviews, my speeches aipuwa nevarungu nevanhu vatema nana Smith nguva idzodzo. Takaona kuti zvavakataura ndozviri kuitika. Kuti ndikasiya nyika inoyi ndaona vanhu vatema vanwa sewage. Nhasi tikunwa sewage muZimbabwe. Mabasa avaitaura vanhu vachiti handifi kuti vamugabe vangatadza kuti pamabasa chihora mari yakakwana. Nhasi tiri kuhora inonzi RTGS. Ine mutungamiriri wenyika akabuda achitaura kuti the strongest currency musadhak musouthern Africa. Nhasi ukavabvunza vakuru vayo kuti pamakabuda paTV muchiti you've got the strongest currency zvaapapi. Vangobwaira bwaira bwaira havasina kana clue. Ukavabvunza nhasi kuti vakuru makati $1 is equivalent to 1 RTGS or 1 bond. Zvaapapi. Vakuru vaiva kubwaira bwaira bwai 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 havana kana answer. Saka handizivi kuti maZimbabweans kana muda kuuzwa unzi this ZANU PF government is a failure muda kuuzwa na vanhu vakaita sei muda kuuzwa sei ndaitaura nevakomana vakaenda kuDRC kuhondo unoona kuti masoja edu ndipo unoona kuti kana tikupusiswa nesadza kana kuti chi akauya vakabvunza kuna zvina vashi vakati vazvina vashi tauya kuhondo kuDRC isusu vamwe vedu vari kupuwa salary dzavo nema US dollars kwaisusu tichapuwawo chii zvina vashi akati akapindura achiti zvikanzi iwewe mpana ukatosunga madhonga ako ukaenda nawe iwewe kunorima munhu wawarimira iwewe anobhadhara madhonga ako here kana kuti anopa mari kumuridzi wemadhongi ndo mubvunzo ndokupindurwa waitwa masoja eZimbabwe nageneral zvina vashi zvikanzi imi muri madhonga angu ndakusungai kuya kuzorima muDRC DRC haibhadhare imimi madhongi DRC inobhadhara imi muridzi wemadhongi ndosaka maakuona vana general Chiwenga vari kuvaka mamansions nemamansions muZimbabwe asi madhongi akaenda kuDRC they got nothing until today almost 20 years after DRC pull out hapana musoja akaenda kuDRC anokwanisa zvitengera butsu kana akatenga imba kana akaita chii vakanyatso kuudzwa point blank nazvina vacho kanzi muri madhongi andasungwa kuya kuzorima kana ndakubhadharwa ndobhadharwa ini ndosaka muri kuona vachivaka mamansions masoja asina chaanacho hanzi how are you brother Yuda atete Barbara zviri sei how far with the diaspora vote you promise to bring some lawyers we are still fighting atete Barbara ndakataura nemalawyers vakati unfortunately izvozvo hazvimo zvekuti tinokwanisa kuingenja an international organization kana kuenda kuan international court to demand our right to vote it's at the discretion of the government saka government knows when it allows us to vote we are going to speak and once we speak the government will go saka hakuna ari kuda kuti titaure ndo respond yandakawana kubva kumagweta andidi mona so if you look at Zimbabwe when we say we gained independence our soldiers were told point blank by Zimbabwe army generals that if you take donkeys to go and plow someone's land the owner of that land is not going to pay the donkeys he's going to pay the owner of the donkeys so Zimbabwe soldiers in DRC were likened to donkeys which were plowing a DRC land and who benefited out of it were the generals who took these kids to go and fight in DRC so they were like donkeys they were never paid only the owner of the donkey was paid this was an answer given to Zimbabwe soldiers by Vitalis zvina vashi during that time who was the army general and to show that these people don't care about you let's go to Marange ko Marange the same soldiers were used to go and shoot and kill people in Marange who were scratching for diamonds instead those soldiers are now guarding the Chinese who are scratching for diamonds but Zimbabweans in Zimbabwe are not allowed to go and scratch for those diamonds to sell to eat Chinese are protected by the army if you are found in Marange diamond fields you are going to be shot but Chinese are never shot so the government is allowing Chinese to take away our wealth whilst we are there smiling and doing nothing so we have become slaves of fear ladies and gentlemen The horror that you witness today, Zimbabwe economy has totally collapsed. ZANU-PF is now panicking. If you look at section what that they've introduced in Zimbabwe, it is just to make Zimbabweans suffer. The people of Zimbabwe are suffering. ZANU-PF is panicking. The economy has totally collapsed. The problem that Zimbabweans did, they did not understand that the incumbent president is a trained saboteur. Someone who doesn't care whether you die or not. We all know what saboteurs do. They can bomb you. They don't care who dies. Children die. Lame people die. Disabled people die. Saboteurs don't care. They don't mind. If you look at what Zimbabweans are facing, saboteurs are not even moved by it. Now, the first 5 years, the 5 year term for Emmerson Mnangagwa is coming to an end. And he has done nothing for you and me. All the promises that they made, they never fulfilled them. And before they fulfill any promise, they are telling you that 2023 is a foregone conclusion. That you must, whether you like it or not, vote for them. 2023. If I ask you, what are you going to vote ZANU-PF for in 2023? What have they done for the benefit of you and the nation? Nothing. Then they are saying you are going to vote for them. For what? They've been there for 40 years, 41 years. What have they done to the nation? Nothing. And they still need you to vote for them. Ladies and gentlemen, it's high time you should wake up from this deep slumber. It's not time to let ZANU-PF play with your mind. They should show us what they did to fulfill jobs. Electricity for all. A lot of promises. Affordable quality healthcare. Nothing came. But they're still vying for your vote. They want you to vote for them. They want you to vote for them. Why should you vote ZANU-PF when they failed to meet the targets they set for themselves? Nobody told them. This is why, you see, I always tell Joe Charamba that you listen, Charamba. You destroyed Robert Mugabe. And today you are destroying Emmerson Mnangagwa. Thanks very much for destroying ZANU-PF, Mr. Charamba. All the promises which were made by Mugabe, most of them came from Joe Charamba. And he is still writing the same promises, the same book. I need him on. So this is why I am saying, ladies and gentlemen, that it's now time for Zimbabweans to think. Zimbabweans must think. And as I say, Kaponela, auya kunyora pa world pang. Zikanze vanhu vanoshandisa zvima fake accounts pa Facebook ndobva ndaseka. Ndikatiponela, a very good example of a fake account is Jamwanda. George Charamba from the president's office anoshandisa fake name. Ndikati wakambonzwa here zita rekunzi ainzani komudhara uyu. Ainzani komunanga kwamastake. And ask secure doko chakuti chakuti zitara kerere. Ndikati ane mazita asingaperi. Ano zvidaidza. Esa kanga ari ma fake names. Saka usa don't worry about my fake accounts on Facebook. Because zvakati zvinotanga zvakatanga nehurumende ne government. Zvakatanga nguva dzehondo. Vachiri kuna vanhu vainzi vana Smart Tembo. Kuna vamwe vainzi vana Rex Nongo. Esangari ma Facebook fake accounts. Ndamutaurira ponera kuti kwaiva na Rex Nongo. Vanateura Europa Nongo. kwaivana smart tembo ese wayo ma fake ana ruka chivende ese aya ma fake Facebook accounts saka ndizeponela kana chigumbuka kuti hanzi pa Facebook pakazara ma fake accounts that president's office spokesperson wa president ai anoshandisa iye kuti jamwanda iya chinzi George Charamba kwaivana na vanhu vainzana Nathaniel Maneru vana Jonathan Moyo vana baba ajukwa ese ma fake accounts vana ruka chivende vana smart tembo ese akanga ari ma fake accounts saka vanhu vezano musanyanya kugumbuka mukaona ma fake accounts akawanda vana chenhamo chimutengwende cheni chimutengwende naifu ari muchaina kana inzi cheni chimutengwende ndasikaziva kuti ishona rinotokanga maputu wanyawanyawanya kana rakudya zvoti guruguruguru asi but you know kuti I only realized a few years ago who Rex Nongo was. Definitely a lot of people never knew who Rex Nongo was. Those were fake Facebook accounts, fake WhatsApp accounts. Akudhara WhatsApp isati yauya vaitiudza zviri kuuya kuti kuchaya inonzi WhatsApp neFacebook munenge muchishandisa mafake accounts, musashandise mareal names enyu. Saka ndopa tainzwa vanhu vainzi ana ruka chivende, ana smart tembo, ana Rex Nongo, ana jamwanda, ana Nathaniel Maneru. Zvakawanda zvainyorwa pano. Saka vanhu vezanu pevu zvazoshata nhasi kuti pane munhu aakuzviti shepadhudha iri fake account. Aiwa musarohwe nehana vakomana, ndimakatanga nazvo. Handiti maona ndazoudza mumwe munhu kana pandakabva muZimbabwe handikuudzi nhau ndakabva nchinzana. So ladies and gentlemen, some people are saying the platform is boring because the platform, you know, haisi kuzotaura zvinoda Zanu PF. It's very unfortunate kana uri weZanu PF uchiya panapa isisi tiri kutaura zvekuti nyika iende mberi. Hanzi mazita ekuhondo nanhasi hondo haina kupera. People of Zimbabwe are still suffering. This is why you see people of Zimbabwe as broadcaster uye zviya ainzani ainzi let me think ainzi ndiye akunzi Webster Sham vamuruti Webster Sham nhasi anga sanganzi Webster Sham ainzi Charles Ndlovu yeah ndaziva nguva dzehondo dzedze ainzi Charles Ndlovu. I think ndiye wama kuti Webster Sham nhasi hapana aimboziva kuti anonzi Webster Sham. Vaiziva nerimwe zita rainzi Charles Ndlovu. A lot of these people vaive nemafacebook page aive nemafalse names ainzi Charles Ndlovu. Aishepadhudha account totoida yadero ingavasvotwe zvavo. Vari kusvotwa Richard Hove exactly mumwe wacho. Saka akanga ari mafake name Caesar vanhu avaitaura. Saka vari kusvotewa nhasi hanzi chiplatform chaakubhohwa kana chinobhohwa kana tichinge taakutaura zvekusunungura Zimbabwe. Ndosaka uri kuona iye zvinoizvi vana vezimbabwe vasvika pakuti enough is enough. Vana vezimbabwe vaa ready for any action. Kana mukatikande matombo vanokanda matombo. Chataakutya ndechekuti pfuti dzinogona kungorira muZimbabwe anytime. Dzinogona kungorira because Zanu PF payasvika apa yapererwa. They've got no clue. Our economy has collapsed. Vatomhanya kutonoita politburo meeting yavaita iri agent. Vachapoenda vanhu kuti chinamasa imboona zvakati iwe imboona zvakati because the economy of Zimbabwe is totally collapsed. Mark my words, 3 months from now, muZimbabwe munenge musichawanikwe chikafu. My shops anenge aempt back again to 2008. Anzi abowe wanewe yudha garo epasi chichi vari kubhoekana mazano. Bose chokwadi chatotaura panapa chinobhohwa and chinorwadza. Because nyaya takachitaura panapa inyaya yakanaka. yekuti muZimbabwe mune vanhu vari kunzi munhu ashaika arova. Imagine the whole human being went missing. The government can't trace where Itai Dzamara is. The government can't trace where Rashiwe Guja is. The government can't trace where Maslin Dzumbira is. Oda munhu aisitsonoka, munhu anorasi kunzi munhu achawanike munyika. Government ikabvunza kuti we've got no clue kuti akaenda kupi. Andimukona nyaya dzati kutaura. Hanza boyo wangaro wepasi. Kungoti angobhoyo usauya hako. Rega tinogato taurira vanenge vachida kunzwa nyaya dzati kutaura. Kuti panapa tinodzidzisana kuti chii chinonzi Zimbabwe. Takabva kupi, tiri kuenda kupi. Taapapi nenyika. Mwanzo tichitaura panapa, tiri kutaura kuti president weZimbabwe is a trained saboteur. Uzama saboteur anofanana nematerrorists ekuMozambique. Ekuti when they come, they wipe the whole village, they behead people. They don't care whether children are killed or not. Saboteurs don't care. They just plant bombs, blow people off. They don't care. Our economy, you bet Angel, a very good, a near miss. You bet Angel. Ukada kuona munhu anonzi you bet Angel. Unotadza kuziva kuti muZimbabwe mune Angel anonzi you bet Angel. That's not his name. He's a very close friend of your president. You bet Angel. Ndoda kutaura kuti kana vachinzwa mweya waMwari. Ngavatiudzewo kune musoro watapiwa nekwakaenda ndege yekuMalaysia. Ukaona pane muprofita ari kunonongedza ndege yeMalaysia, vanhu vanomuta Mwari kuti iri papa. Hanzi kana musoro wemwana chaiwo vakaramba nawo. So pathetic. These killers. Ukaona vanhu vaakupinda kureligion kuda kunoshandisa zvimafake prophets izvi kuti hanzi uyai mutikovere vanhu. Vati votere 2023. Muno voterwa maitei? Kariba demu. Yakanga yapwa. Matadza. Kutipa mabasa. Mayutha ari kumhanyira twabani. Ndazonyora vandikati. Anenge akarambwa nechimukadzi chanya. Hanzi mukadzi chanya ndechekupi Ethiopia. Vamwe vatanzi Ethiopia here. I don't know. I don't even know. I wasn't following him. Aive nemumwe mukadzi waive naye, so hamene ndowaiwana mari here dzaiuya nadzo achidisplaya achiratidza vanhu achikwira pamusoro pezvimotokari zvimamamogini zvakango. Ozo zvafanana nemuno muuk. If I want that car andiende kunoitenga ndonohaya. MaZimbabweans chavasingazivi, helicopter can hire a helicopter. Ndotosukana ndiri mudenga nehelicopter. I can hire a Lamborghini for a week. Ndosikana chitenderera naisha noise ba 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 ne Lamborghini. Vanhu vakatoona nzi Judha atenga Lamborghini. Ma western countries akanaka. You can hire those things. I can hire it for a year. Ndogara nayo gore rese vanhu vachifo ndatenga mota. Ndo vari kubawo chenisa gold kunze kwenyika. Anambabva iwewo kumwera unochifukura ka diamond one kuti utengese ipfuti mumusoro. Ukaenda kumarangi kumadiamonds unorwadziwa. Kune varombo vekupedzesera vakavaka dzimba pamusoro pemadiamonds. Havakwanisi, havabvumirwi kumachera kunotengesa. MaChina anouya ochera vakagadwa nemasoja vachitakura vachienda. Musoja ari kugadha muChina ari kuora RTGS, haana mari yaanowana. We must wake up. Hanzi machief must be removed in the next government. Yeah, I don't think we need chiefs anymore. But they are serving no purpose. Kana Air Force One to hire. And more. So I don't think Zimbabwe needs my chiefs anymore. But they are serving no purpose. And in more. So ladies and gentlemen, let me call it quits for tonight. I think you have enjoyed this presentation. Those who came late, you can go on Shepherd You, the channel, YouTube, subscribe, and follow all the videos that you want. Great teaching from Mr. Yuda. Yuda? Yuda. Mfana wangu Zimbabwe. Yuda, 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 yuda. Mfana wangu Zimbabwe. Aroza. Nopo kara njifungwa wani sene mwiyaka mboya se. Kakaru mpoma nye mwezo wa sene mkashi. Hansi kutunga usika kari bademu ya pole ya pera mvura utu tu. Matu oto chayo chayo. Hansi blawayo yese thanks mkoma man. Blawayo about 650,000 people in Blawayo. They've got 6 police cars. Ukaitika crime wando mirira kuti motikari yaenda wakati ikadzoka yozouya. Unofa wakamirira yo. Zanu PF. Ine motikari dzinopfura motikari dzegovernment. A political party no Zanu PF. Ine ma latest 4x4 vehicles. Asina police. Asina army. Asina prison. Imagine. Kuti Zanu PF. President of Zimbabwe is the richest person in SADC. Zimbabwe inyika iri kusurvive on donors. But in a richest president, ukaenda unoona blue roof. Hakuna kana ku South Africa hakuna imba inenge blue roof, hakuna. Ukaona mansions ari kuvakwa na chiwenga. Hakuna ku South Africa ndoverenga. Ma mansions ari kuvakwa na chiwenga. Paka ipo wako mani. Ndakaru waziwa angu. Kuti masoja edo wakano parara mdiarasi. Vai uzwa. Vai uzwa masoja. Kunzi janzi marino piwa dongi ere. Kana kuti marino piwa muridzwe madongi. Mamanshon zaru kuwa kwa ni waridzwe madongi. Mamanshon zaru kuti anzi mnonzi msati vunze. Ne kuti yoye uri dongi chete. Wakanori mamunda, inini muridzwe dongi ndindojika. Nisa waru kuwaka, mamansions asinga iti wanachuenga. Wala munu wana nuwaka 4 mansions. Munu wana rumzi babu wana waka 50 bedroom dows. Minister. 50 bedrooms. Ayoka, imi msani ma bedroom yekuta mba na oge. Iwe waka kamba kane 3 bedroom, luone mapembe rauno ita. Kuna waru kuwaka 50 bedrooms. Kamu vuzi wadu wana 50, wana 50. Ani gano wana 3 sa mgabe. Hali waka blue roof. Nika yudu, mgabe waka waka imba ineka lift mkati. Waka wana wanda kitchen, wanda wakira lift. Kwa bako wana wanda bedroom norara nungo gara, wakira lift wanda bedroom norara. Pa mbeda bayo nungo shiko gara pa side, osi muzo khao shiko kuturu wapo orara. Kutsira. It's a total tragedy really. Tabo, I think now I can try to aid you here. And in the morning, it's a real tragedy. We have got a clueless government. People who tell my soldier, kuti muri madongi, amu badagwimi, no badagwaini muri zwe dongi. My soldier is Zimbabwe osekerere. Asi sinofani mwaku vondokera kuma towns kusina ma resources akakwa na strategy lose. And ili maona. How are you Mbongise Numudawa, how are you? So you find that Zimbabwe generals told our Zimbabwe National Army in DRC that you are just donkeys. You've come to plow this land. The owners of Congo are not going to pay donkeys. They are going to pay the owner of the donkeys. Today, if you go to Zimbabwe, the owner of the donkeys, they build blue roofs. They are building mansions and mansions. One general building 4 mansions. And the donkey doesn't have anywhere to put up. The donkey is starving. Ladies and gentlemen, donkeys are starving. Owners of the donkeys are building mansions. The chwengas are building 4 or 5 mansions. Whilst the donkeys in the camouflage are starving. So it's all up to Zimbabwe soldiers to think. We have got a war again in Mozambique that is coming your way. You are still a donkey going to Mozambique to fight for donkey owners to build mansions. You must be a crazy lot. If you see a Zimbabwe soldier going to Mozambique to fight, you are a crazy lot. You should learn from others who participated in DRC. I was talking to a brother of mine. And I won't put that again. Anyway, come back. You didn't get anyone on gun. I was asking a friend, Ndigati kampani, inenge ine vanhu vangani. Kuti kampani, zvikanishapiro kampani inogona kuda vanhu 120. Inogona kuda vanhu 120. So you mean kuti pakarwa 3 Brigade C kampani, 120 soldiers were shot dead. Yeah, more than that, were killed in Cabinda. And someone is saying, these are donkeys. Don't pay donkeys. You pay all of donkeys. And they are building mansions. This is painful. You might see me smiling when talking about this. But it's the most painful thing that has ever haunted Zimbabweans. And it will never end in the people of those soldiers. Those who are buried in Congo today. These soldiers were like sinking in swamps, and the rebels would just come and chop the head off. That's your gravy. Most Zimbabwean children in the DRC are in swamps until today. The government never ever tried to bring the bodies back home. We've got thousands and thousands of Zimbabwe soldiers lying dead in the DRC. And someone in Zimbabwe is busy building mansions, blue roof, 50-bedroomed houses, and so forth. They are planning another war in Mozambique to send more children, Zimbabwe children, to go die. It's so pathetic, Atete Barbara, that a general will call his soldiers donkeys and say, donkeys are not supposed to be paid. The owner of Hanzi ukasunga madongi iwe ukaenda kunorimira munhu munda make anobhadharwa madongi here kana anobhadharwa muridzi wemadongi. Ndo zvakataurwa na general zvinavashe. Masoja aida akapindura kana aiwa muridzi wedongi ndiye anobhadharwa saka endai kubasa. I'll get paid. I'll build mansions. I'll buy my children, my farms. I'll, everything. They took everything for themselves. And the soldiers are suffering. So I'm appealing to Zimbabwe soldiers that it's only you guys who can free themselves. Don't be allowed to suffer. You have suffered enough. This is what I'm calling Chichi. That we are. You are the Zimbabweans. You are the soldiers. Aungataurirwa wakabata pfuti. Nemunhu kuti hanzi iwewe donga hausundiwe unobhadharwa. Ndichabhadharwa ndini. And the Zimbabwe soldiers, they thought that was a joke. And they spent years and years in DRC, went back home. They were paid nothing. And the chokwadi, it came up. Those owners of these donkeys, they are building mansions today. Vafana vakaenda kuDRC kunorwa hondo yacho vazhinji vari mumajere vazhinji vakajarwa vakasara kuDRC hama dzavo vakadzi vavo vana vavo they are struggling they are suffering ndo vana vafana vanoona vachiita madrugs vasina chekudya kurara ma streets it's so painful zvina washe used that man to build a private school he built his own school kutonovaka chikoro Nemari. I understand Pakafa Kabila Joseph Agaisa Mari kuma almost 500 million, almost half a billion. Ya akapa Zimbabwe government. Could please pay those soldiers to come and help me to fight. And that money was converted to their personal use. Varubaka waka waka zvikoro, waka waka ma mansions, vakaita say at the expense of our children. Our blood. People are still suffering. Kabunza mnagenda DRC. Mbom bunza 3 years za waka gara. Chicha unacho. Imba auna. Kanaka basikoro chaira auna. pekurara hapa hauna. Chekudya hauna, you are starving. Instead, government is criminalizing most of them, sending them to prison. Ukaenda uchikuru maximum mbora ariko ku prison mbora. Ukamubvunza ndakaita armed robbery. Why ndanga ndisina chekudya? Vese anzi mbora ariko uchikuru maximum life in prison. Andakaita murder. Ukazona musoja afungwa ndakunoita murder, zvirina ndibe. Okuurayira mudzanga wofodya. Zvaura these soldiers are not paid enough. Yenezvo vanofanha vari kudzigadzirirai muende kuMozambique nodimburwa musoro nemajihadists. Dai ndiri ndini, dai ndiri tirofanha vaive nekuti tichingosvika tichingomhara kuMozambique takutotena pfuti kutodzoka kuZimbabwe. Chototsva kuZimbabwe kwacho. Why do you want us to continue die in foreign land whilst we are benefiting nothing? Wars that benefit individuals. Wars that doesn't benefit a soldier. Vazhinji vakafirako kuMozambique kuDRC. And vana vakafira mahara. Vana vavo vari kutambura izvozvo. Pana chavakawana. Vakadzi dzangosara dzaanherera. Ndopataimba tikati vakomana mazvipira here. Zvekuti tiende paCongo. Vana baba mune mari here. Yekuti tiende paCongo. Mabuzman shera, shera, shera. Mabuzman shera, shera, shera. Mabuzman shera, shera. Nandi aga shauraga. Ndine squad yema soja. Wana wafana wai chema. Kuchema msoja. Wui, wui, wui. Naka sonzi nengwa mbana kwa mtari kanzi blaz. Murudu zora ndanga roza kaka ipa. Nika dinda wa mnina shukanza. Kama putitsa kaka ipa mdara. Apa naiko tendera kembi chete 3-1, pa 3-1, pa naiko tendera kembi chete. Kote vana baba mune mari here, tse kuti tiende kuCongo. Ova koma na mazvipira here, tse kuti tiende kuCongo. Mabuzmani shera, 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 mabuzmani shera, mabuzu, shera, mabuzmani shera, mabuzu. Mabuzman shera, 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 mabuzman shera. Mam, daga rova, dino fana, battery brigade, but squeeze, I'm quiz, so, daga zom, misoz, one kuchema. Anza, daga zom, the mom soldiers, ganza, you are awesome, so, you are awesome, gadji, you got it as soldier. Then in the house, ganz, tukto kuda mpana, tukto kuda army. Naipasina command, and one wines matching outa, diaga sojam, gaga taiwa. Mukatitorerawo vana Yuda vatakatraina kuti vabatsire vamwe vakutraina. Tinosara tisina krimuka. Kutaprojusawo munhu one watofungidzira kuti kana unoita watofungidzira kuti vanogona kubatsira. Imoti movada. Zvikanzi transfer presidential guard ngaaende mupano. Kana komandendo wangu akazojamuka. Hanzi ini mwana hanzvadzi yangu akatiza aiswa pafrand akavhundutswa nemafiro aiita masoja. He went awu. Vazhinji vakaenda awu. Pamunozva takaimba dirihora iro vanogara mudiriwo dirihora rembanje vanogara mudiriwo vakomana vanogara mudiriwo dirihora rembanje vanogara mudiriwo usatambe navo vanogara mudiriwo dirihora rembanje vanogara mudiriwo dirihora vakomana gara mudiriwo dirihora rembanje vanogara vana dirihora iro ayayayaya. Hanzi mudara nemweya wehondo. Hondo, izvozvo zvino zvaitipa zvivindi vakoma. Handini maona. Hanzi zuvari, zuvari richingobuda. Moyo wangu wadzungaira. Moyo chena usandi chemendo ndandoga. Pahukama wakaura, ndimi wakauraya. Wakaura, ndiwe wakauraya. Wakauraya. Wakauraya, hazvina mhosva, hapahukama. Saka ndati kana takarova kuseni nevafana, ndomazuva ekuti vana chidhumo, madzuva akaurava vana chidhumo, vanhu vakuda kuzati waiti kafamba muHarare, waona kombi yakanzi chidhumo. Kafamba waona, saka ndaibvunza kuti saka vanhu ava, vanomboziva here kuti vari kupembedza mbavha, kuti hanzi chidhumo mhondi. Saka ndopatakabva tataka kukaimba maikati. Ndikati Chidumo takauraya. Chidumo takauraya. Chidumo takauraya. Hazvina mhosva. Imbavha. Chidumo takauraya. Chidumo takauraya. Chidumo takauraya. Hazvina mhosva. Imbavha. Hanzembe dzake dzere neropo. Chidumo takauraya. Hazvina basa imbavha. Andiona. Achimboimba. Ayo. Ayo makomo, makomo ari kure. Ayo makomo, andifungisa Zimbabwe. Ayo makomo, makomo ari kure. Ayo makomo, andifungisa Zimbabwe. Rege, akakarokakarorpa kongo, unotochema chete. Regera kuchema, vakataura, regera kuchema. Zimbabwe tichanoitora. Ai, unochema chete. Pane kamwe kandaitika ndadhinikana manje. Pane kamwe kasonga ndaiti ndikada kuona vanhu vachichema musi iwoyo. Ndaibva ndakatanga. Ndaiko katanga sefani zvangu. Fani vachimacha. Ndombotanga kukarova ikakakuti hanzi. Ndikahanza iwe mhani. Chichi, unoridza mhere. Hanzi mira ndikafunge ikango ndaigara ndakakaimba manje kuti kure unoudzwa nani ikangoka ndaigara kuti vanhu vacheme ndokandaitanga ika kure unoudzwa nani kure mwana akachema uri kure unoudzwa nani Baba vakarwara uri kure uchaudzwa na kure unoudzwa nani kure baba vakarwara uri kure unoudzwa nani Haibva mukadzi akatorwa uri kure unoudzwa nani Haibva ona munhu anogara pasi kubata musoro kuchema kuti kochii hanzi hamudhara mandidzosera kumba mukadzi arutorwa ndiri kure ndozwanana kwamwana wangu akarwara ndiri kure ndozwanana apa ndane 3 months mudhara 4 months ndiri musango hanzi maithem this alliance must see this vanofanira kudzidza hanzi kosoja masoja mbererembere nenyika vamwe akagarika zvavo mudzimba masoja mbererembere nenyika Mwakagarika zvavo mudzimba masoja mberere mberere nenyika wega unonyatsozwa njombo iyi unoda kwakapfeka pepa njombo hauizwi kuti hanzi ndakapfeka bhutsu makumbo andiri maona zvinhu zvokuti taiti kana tikatanga kuchimbumura so ukatarisa gunman ndiaindispaka especially vafanha vepa presidential guard vafanha vepa presidential guard ndakamhoenda parenji mwemusi hanzi idzave dzehondo chaidzo pakaipaneti ndakamhoenda panational range mwemusi ndobva ndasvika zvangu ndikaona vafanha vachirova dzavairova vafanha vapaPG saka vanoziva pandakasvika parenji paPG vaive kuB range chichi unoziva kuB range handipave nemain range cleveland woenda paB range pakarange kaive paipai paside paipai kaive zvichuru zvezve ndakasvika presidential guard ichigadzirira kuenda kuDRC saka ndasvika paipai ndakangosvika ndikamira saka pane one mupanhu aiziva kuti uyu munhu ndiinstructor but handakangosvika kubva ndapretend as if munhu waase muguard jerowo zvake an ordinary guard saka vairova mafalling plates havairova so vachirova mafalling plates ndobva ndasvika kubva ndangomira ndikaona vachiridza vachirova vachinzi vachichinjana vachipinda vachirova saka ndakazokumbira kune mumwe paive na WO1 aivepo WO2 angari WO2 aivepo ngariko shefu ndachikumbira wakanomboridza iyo pfuti handiizive zvikanzi pfuti ipi kaiyo mugadjero iyo ndoanauze sks hereyo kana aiwa tongoishandisa kudhiru chete asanamboiridza zvikanzi oh zvikanzi ha mupenyere enda unoloda unoziva unolodwa sei vandapomwa musoja akandidzidzisa zvikanzi inonzi skse inotwa sososo ya ndauzara kuti sachikara inotwa sososo unoloda sososo kutikapa 10 rounds ako bva kutikatyo obva warara apa uno emason pfutiyo haina kusiyana neak chichi ha dzandidzisadzisa paipai ndikati ah thank you chef zvikanzi right andiri izvo unozviziva zviri uko kumberi uku kubattle tatira about 300 meters away ndikati zvikanzi zvinonzi zvimafalling plates izvo zviya zve saka unota se unonosvika urara ukada uchiruva unoema paside so pakona uri bam uchiridza zvikanzi mira ndokuratidza obva mudhara yarara arara aindidzisisa uya vachipotsa vazochirova saka kwakwasara zvimwe 5 zvazvaangomirawo zvikanzi wazviona izvo zvandanichirova izvo ndikati zvikanzi rova izvozvo ndikati hamasvita shevha ndanodha yangu ndobva ndarara oza ndakazotengeswa nashuma manje shuma ndari rekomando rere hamandiraitsvage ikoko saka ndakarara paibva ndanyatsosimudzira mushemushebva ndanyatsotora falling plate rangu ndobva ndatiaradona next varadona next saka ndandasara ne2 ndakadonedza 3 ndasara ne2 saka ndakukonsentera kuti ndirove rechi 4 riyariya ndakanzwa ndatsikwa mutsipa manje zvikanzi uri tsvagei pano iwo koshevu saka taime yandakasimudza musoro ndikuona ndishuma akanditsika mutsipa rekukomando rero hanzi rudei pano kati ndabokuyazokumbira uridza sks zvikanzi uzati vanhu varoenda kudiarasiera ndikati zvikanzi kuwestira one time bva pano iwe ndikati akoshevu zvikanzi uyu munhu ndiinstructor munhu uyu ndiweapons instructor anocompita anocontesta panapa every year havana futi asinamboridza panapa ari kuwestira time ora saka ndakazobvapo ndayatoitoi zvikanzi tambomak time ndambomupisa imbichana kuti azoziva kuti haazviite next time ndakazonzi na1 pano vatamba nezitokwadza pana bva pano ndaramazvita chefu kana ndachida kuridzawo skes achibva pano saka ndakazobvapo ndaakudzokera kumain range andiriwaona saka nyaya yati kutaura inyaya yakanaka ikuziva kuti tine vakomana vana vakapararira kudrc vana ava vakaenda kuhondo kunorwira nyika asi vaive nemapromises ekuziva kuti pavanobvawo ikoko kubasaka kana ndikanoshandira kuuk ndapuwa kambani yanditi ndanogara kuuk 3 years uchishandira ikoko ndine maallowances andofanira kuwana ndine mari yandofanira kupiwa andiwana vakomana vedu ekucongo havana chavakapiwa vakatotukwa kanzi muri madhongi mari dzakauya kuzimbabwe dzakavaka zvikoro dzikavaka mamansions avo mapersonal businesses avo avari kurana nhasi vana havana chavakawana musaka muna takutaura achiti kure 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 unozwana rekure kure mwana akarwara uri kure unoudzwana baba vakarwara uri kure unoudzwana mukadzi akarwara uri kure unonzwana kure 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 unoudzwana tiri kure kana mwana akarwara mukadzi akarwara mwana akafa unonzwanana hapana uri musango rukachana vakapera kufa masoja edu vachifira musango munyika yavasingazivi ndaitaura nabhururu wangu zvikanzi shepadi ndapona paambush iyoyo ndakakrola svika ndabuda mufiring range firing zone ndobva ndasimuka bva ndarova pasi handaimhanya handaiziva kwandaienda drc is a thicket unongomhanya hauti uzivi kwauri kuinda wozonobudira wongofambawo musango wozonobudira kwanozoona kuti vanhu vacho veko language hauizivi andiri kuona chimbeta akati musatanga ndoine ropa rufu kuparadza matambudziko mukati mehondo satanga imwe hondo ndohondo yava kutanga imwe instead yekuti vati address ishu yemasoja edu vakaparara kudrc compensation vana vobhadharwa vane hama dzakafira kudrc vowanawo zvavanowana vandavenaendezvikoro They don't care about us at all. Saka ndakutaura kuti kusaita care kwavo kwakufanira kutisimudza. Mweya uya wakaita tiende kuhondo yechimurenga ngaugare muvanhu. Zvatakaendera kuhondo yechimurenga ndozvatiri kuvabvunza nhasi kuti chii chatakaachivha semaZimbabweans. Ukada kusimudza muromo wokubvunza waakunzwa panduka. Ndanzwa amai vanga vachitaura, muwo veterani ataura mashoko andibata. Vakati handizvo zvatakaendera kuhondo. Vapo makuona ava vazhinji vacho never went pa front kunorwa hondo. Vanhu vaigara kunana Mozambique vachitendera vachichinja vakaenda kuZambia vodzoka voenda uko. Havana mbopinda muZimbabwe kuti vasangane nezvatakasangana nazvo. Worse still hondo yeCongo, which was worse than iyo yechimurenga. Yanga iri gorira. This was conventional. Takaruza vana vakawanda. Vana inherera. Na nasa vana kuzvikora vasikuenda. Ukanasa ikonomi yacho yabva yatoparara. Kuparara zvachose. Zimbabwe economy is totally collapsed. Havana kana any idea yavanayo to move our country forward. I think my brother was lucky to survive. He was lost for 4 months. Zvinorwadza. Hudukata. Chichi wakudzokera musango. Nyaya inorwadza totaura panapa. Inyaya yekuti kaitaura munhu akaenda kuCongo DRC akanzwa nechitaura anochema. Inini handina kuenda kuhondo yeCongo. Bandakaenda for business sake. Ndaitenderera kusvika kunana Kivu, nana Lubumbashi. Majinda aya nemajindi chitengesa. But my stories atakaona nezvatainzwa kunana Lubumbashi kwataenda kunana Kivu ko. Waitu kashikako kunana Goma. Goma is a big town, very big town. Waitu nyaedza wainzwa kashika ikoko so wainzwa tsitsi. And waitu ukashika kweko wakangokwa identify kuti muZimbabwe. Inda ndine lucky rekundaitaura chiyao, chichewa. Saka ndaini kataura chichewa aifunga ndobva kuZambia. Mandero. Kusvika maindibvunza senemu yangu yekuti Yuda, it's not common unana Zimbabwe. It's found in Tanzania. Nekunana Malawi. Saka pandaisvika ndaitaura chichewa. Saka vai vazhinji vacho vaifunga kuti mundirimuchi ndobvawomandabva muMalawi andidoona. Saka ndaenda chinooda majini, chinooda chii chitengesa zvakaenda. Ndozvaendesa kuDRC. But zvinorwadza. Ukafamba Congo une pamwe pakuti ukasvika ukafamba. Munofamba musango mekuti unorwa kana kuti about 800 kilometers usina kumboona town kana munhu kana chii. Muri musango thicket. DRC, it's a very big country. Nofamba 800 kilometers, 1,000 kilometers, unambona kana town. Kana settlement, kana chi. Ukazwa rwizi runonzi Congo River. Unozano. Ukazwa runonzi Congo River. Kazambezi mwana, Zambezi mwana. Where is it? Ukazwa river, runonzi Congo River. Probably one of the widest rivers in Africa, inland. And it's more. A river is not a lake, it's a river. But probably one of the widest. And rim thicket. Mekuti kana wakufamba Congo River. Auto farm because unoruma nenyo. Unoruma kune nyoka dzimwe dzokuti kana nhasi. Kana ubvunza munhu anzwa kuti mune nyoka dzirumu. Haufambemo. Hanzi ndiri mudiki hangu but zvinodzimba. Zvinorwadza nete. Saka what we want as Zimbabweans is let's stop interfering in these wars. Dzekune dzimwe nyika. Vana Mozambique is a very big country. Zimbabwe inopinda kana ka 4 Mozambique. Let the Mozambicans do their own war. Let them fight their own war. Don't send our soldiers there. I don't hesitate to tell our soldiers kuti wangonzwa kunzi Mozambique, turn your gun kumunarukudza kuti handi kuMozambique. Turn your gun. Zambezi taura hako chichi. Zambezi muzukuru werwizi. Congo River, probably the widest in Africa. Andiona, kaZambezi kamwana. Kamwana. Saka ndiri kutaura endi makarwe ari muCongo River, mune makarwe mamwe anofara ma 200 years, kuti ukapinda unongonzi tsam 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 watopera. Andiona. Kwakapera maZimba vachinji vakapera rukano, masoja dai tubatwa chikarwe mumwe machirwa nemakarwe achienda, chifa. Andiona. Saka nyaya yatiri kutaura pande kuti I'm encouraging masoja edari kuZimbabwe, my saving soldiers. Upenyu ndehwako. Zimbabwe government has shown daina basa neupenyu wema soldier e Zimbabwe. A good example, tarisai zvirikuitwa vanhu vakaenda kuDRC. Havana chawakawana. Imozonzi peshu peshu mudzi mupuwa chii. Muchapuchapuwa chii. Kwana mai kunzi hanzi deployment Mozambique. Itotaura, turn your guns to them. Tell them, bug love. Majaira kupesa vana wenyika e Zimbabwe. Andini mwana. Saka nyaya yatakutaura ndeye kuti Zimbabwe government iripo doesn't care about people. It's a government yakaya ne coup and it can be removed still by a coup. Last time ndakataura ndikati the deepest river in the world, taura yenyu mukoma Simba, that's Congo River for you. Last time ndakataura ndikati vana veZimbabwe, masoja edu eZimbabwe varipo at the moment, musabvume kushandiswa. Shandaka wana wafano, wachi manyam town, wachi riza putu, wachi pura wanu, ma innocent civilians, that must be first and last, and those who were involved by must face the law. Hakuna muna anu vumiro urawa mzimbabu. Andi mwana. Imima ati vumiro tumufe mura yu. Musa kwa chona tichengela masoja, edu like this, to zani masoja ndedu, asi masoja izanu. Ndurukunzo wa zanu pia vijitani zikano shandra army, Urimso jawe zanu. No. Ivaima wata ora kuti deployment no. Kana mitri masoja. And you turn those weapons to them. And tell them bug love. Push them. Send them to prison. And so what is the difference between a gorilla and a conventional home commercial? Thanks Atete Barbara. Thank you for a very good question. Wondo kusiana kwa zaka ita gorilla home. I wondo ya kuti. Kana tishiruwa wana tishiruwa tese panapa. Imimi muri ma regular enyika inini ndichinzi ndiri mu rebel zvaita ma war veteran ma comrades kudara vaisvika vo ataka vokanda ma grenades voridza ma AK vobva va disappear votiza voenda saka is sort of vaingo disappear zvino zvaka ndiro kutra explain zviri simple zvekuti munhu wese anogona kunzwisisa saka haisi hondo yekuti Muto ingenjana kuridzirana yakasiyana iyi hondo yekuti magorira anongosvika ongovataka kuti vatiza wena vakatiza vanonoungana somewhere else hamuchavaoni saka vanhu vanongosvika votema ine matombo odisappear votema ine matombo opinda mubush odisappear vakasiyana neconventional war. Conventional war is an engagement war yekuti imimi pamunenge muchienda vanenge vachiuya Moto sangana, moto rizirana. Kushika moto nata awapera. Awapera, awakuriru. So you will find out conventional home. Yaga seya ne gorira home. Bakuti. Awa, the way you engage. Muhondo, ndo kuseya na wazakaita. Kugorira, ndo kuna kugara muvanu. Ini ndri mgorira. Ndile futi yangu. Asindaka feka kwevanu. Ndoto enda kumunda kuna wabasira kurima. Ndri msoja. Ndoto rima na avo kumunda. Masoja akauya ndovarambira vanoravuza mambona magandanga kuti tinombona magandanga masoja achipfura achienda ndosara ndoburisa pfuti yangu kokoko ndoropfura nekumashure ndobva ndatiza ndoenda andimona conventional war haidaro man bozi unongoshitona kuti awo masoja ayo masoja moto engenjana moto rovana hapana anotiza kuzotiza kukurirwa unongona kutiza but you don't disappear so it's a very simple kungokombeya kuziva kuti magorira vanorara nepfuti vanenge vachigara vachitiza vachienda vachita zvavanenge vachiita vachienda hanzi yeye 1 August yakaputika ane zvafanana nekuti zvakaitika kana kunonzi kuchiti kataura kuti kuti mu understand gorira all the way it is done iwe yekuti magorira acho kazhinji kacho kana kuti sa mawo vesi ari magorira vanga vasina kana uniform yekuti why identify Wazikanikonzi uniform yo. Ndeye kupi. Vashinji wacho wangu peka different info yembe. Wangu peka majini. Because what you only do in gorilla war. You don't want to be identified. Kuti urimsoja ukupi kwa urimsoja ere. Unungwa kaita hide everything into people. Unungwa na kuwanda mne vanu. Unungwa na ramba magone puti. Unungwa na kuita sei pa chigorilla. Unungwa na kuparta uruega. Wana kupata murika na 5 kana 10 murika small group mungoshika mwataka panu pamba katakatakata mutiza mwende ano conventional aidaru manji you can even identify with I am my soldier I ask my soldier avakapfika inifomu yakati vakapfika inifomu mutoro wevana kuinge njani kana muchinovataka besi munozata kunovataka besi hapana rutiza tunovataka besi kusvika tarova masoja ipo totora besi over andimona saka zvakafanana nekuti ukada kuona DRC wo yanga iri hondo yanga isingarwiwe nemarebels ataiti magorira yanga itori hondo yaitorwiwa nemasoja eRwanda neBurundi neUganda vakabatana vachirwisa masoja eDRC saka engagement yacho yanga itori different negorirawo. If you look at issues zvotaurwa dzekukabhinda kuti vakomana vedu vesikambani 3 brigade vakanopinda muambush because vanotoset ambush yekutomeka sure kuti hapana anorarama ipapo kwazona paambush maakurohwa kunzi tag kwanza vatanga kunzi tag kunoko ichinzi tag kumusoroko munenge matopinda mese mukilling zone paambush pane inonzi killing zone munopinzwa mukilling zone kana vamumeka sure kuti mese mapinda mukilling zone voshitanga kuda shurai manzi hapana vanoburuka uchitiza uchienda paambush vanhu vakaita ambush vanokuudzai kuti kupona paambush haakuda kwamwari imimi you can engage back but unoza kuingenja unokuingenja uchiziva kuti vanhu vari umu vari how powerful vanhu vangani imimi vanenge vachitokuverengai muri mumotokari muchikrosa kudai kuti yapinda iyo mukilling zone yapinda yapinda kana maa mukilling zone woita madiro nemi uchijamba usangana nebara zvibhomba ipapo zvigrenade movo kana wapona ipapo paambusha mwarane vanhu asaka isu tikuda gorirawo ndiyo yakafita zano handifungi kuti muzimbabwe muchada gorirawo bush wo haisina basa muzimbabwe we don't need bush wo watete babo I don't think bush wo will work muzimbabwe because muzimbabwe the good part is army iripo probably the weakest so far hapana kana vane experience vafana vazhinji vakaenda kuDRC vakabuda mabasa ukaona asara akaenda kuDRC vakungotiwo hapana zvekuita handina kwokuenda handina pekugara ndo vamwe vanhu vangosara vangobatirira but it's almost 20 years now munhu akaenda kuDRC anongosevha musoja anosevha 20 years chete muarmy wotobuda saka vanhu vaapo zvino izvi vazhinji vafana vanyowani vese ukatotarisa kuti soja turipo zvino izvi ndokana ichitarisa patikoposta mapicture ato kuti vafana vatoya kuti baba bazuka ngozi gidhi panapa chete wota manyoka i unouma adoro unouma saka you find out kuti vafana vatinatwodu kana ukada kutitesta ina unotirwera stand 2 uonotiumira here tufana kana uoma kakamira sokuweta takamborwerawo mwafana vafana vesapota takamborwera stand tunalunga vafana vakadhota kuti taatakwa pano so you find a lot of things that needs to be understood saka tine basa rakanaka rekuti vana vezimbabwe we have tried for 41 years endurance Zimbabweans have endured brutality from black government for 41 years we have endured brutality hanzi jungle house must be the killing zone ndo killing zone yao ndo vazhinji vakaperera imomuya so Zimbabweans have endured 41 years of government brutality ZANU-PF brutality they have even tried to be silent not to try to make a war we have been peaceful for 41 years but kwazvakuenda now I think peace does not work anymore ndoti mubate mashoko andirikutaura panapa ekuti peace in Zimbabwe does not work anymore vana vavo ndovava nemagold mines everything ndovana ndovakadya mari dzekongo dzese hapana an ordinary Zimbabwean paari kubenefita ukaenda kungoda nebadza kuti unochera kuti uwanewo one dombo rekutengesa utengesadza you are shot by police by soldiers but machina are guarded to loot so you understand that they don't care about Zimbabweans anymore what they care is about looting selling everything to countries like China and everything maZimbabwe they can't benefit from their mineral resources so peace does not work anymore ndoza ndogona kutaura handichakwanisa kusipedza nechismile because ndakutonzwa misodzi yangu kuda kubuda kuti vana veZimbabwe chatakatadza chii ndisitakauraya Jesu here kumwari havasi kuona here kutambura kwatiri kuita toitei sevana vezimbabwe because we have been peaceful for 41 years despite ZANU-PF coming abducting people killing people vazhinji vakafira mahara vanhu vaai abductwa vachiurawa vanhu muchisetwa mabhesi vachienda mabhesi vanhu vachirohwa until now the Zimbabweans havana musi wavakambofunga kuti haa taneta regai tidzorere but kwataa kuenda uku kwakuratidza taneta manje 41 years is not a joke vanhu muchingorohwa every day muchipfurwa muchiurawa every day muchingoti mwari achapindira mwari achapindira kwataa kuenda uku ndofunga kwakwana manje kana mwari vachipindira ndokupindira kwavaakuita kuti 2023 handifunga kuti inogona kusvika 2023 vanhu vasina kuta mvukela nzara yapo zvika 3 months to come mark my words mumashops munenge maempty musina chekudya kuti uende kusouth africa kuti uimporte goods vari kuramba kombi yakunzi ngaitanga yarejistwa na auxilia munangagwa kuti ione kufamba haubvumirwe kuita mari nekombi yako runzi kwa zupo is a competitor not a regulator so you find a lot of buses akunzi ngapinde muzupo havachadi competition iwo akunzi wecompetitor wako ndiye regulator wako hakuna zvakadaro saka is killing Zimbabweans kushaya hanya nevana vezimbabwe evangelist zviri sei saka ndakutaura kuti peace we have maintained the peace for 41 years and we said no to fighting for 41 years now we got to a break point this break point where we are now we are for suffering in foreign land people and what about Jerusalem zvakaoma kara Zimbabweans have suffered for 41 years they have resisted civil unrest in our country despite the government a waging war against unarmed civilians. We have said no to fighting. We have maintained the peace for 41 years. And now we are at a breaking point. You go to South Africa, you get killed. You go to Mozambique, elsewhere, you get killed. So we better die in our country. If it means fighting, we better go and fight back home. Because we are sick and tired of a government that does not care about its own people. Zimbabweans are suffering. If you go to Zimbabwe today, you tell me. Zimbabweans are really suffering. Ndakaenda ku Zimbabwe 2013. Ndakaenda ku Zimbabwe 2013. Zvandakaona nezvandiri kufunga nhasi kuti yave. Pane vanhu vari, ndakamwona ndakazomusendera picture yangu ndiri ku Zimbabwe. Ndikati, ungachiramba ndakapinda mu Zimbabwe. Upinde mu Zimbabwe ndakapinda. Vanamusendera picture yangu ngati picture yendiri kuzimbabwe imwe yacho ndobva ndaisa paprofile pavo ndiri kuzimbabwe so you will find that things are now bad from what we saw and what we know it's now high time Zimbabweans must learn to free themselves if it means fighting I think it will take years panofiwa panoitika zvakawanda hondo inoitika zvakawanda ndimaona We didn't want war. Nobody wants war in our country. We didn't want war. But the government has been waging war against you, if you don't know. That there was war waged by the government against you. Zimbabweans never wanted war. But you're being abducted, that's war. You're being killed, that's war. The likes of 29 Ndira were murdered. The likes of Wanatonde wakaurawa, Wanakauzano wakaurawa. If you look at since 2000 up to now, MDC or Zimbabweans, over 5,000 to 6,000 Zimbabweans were killed by ZANU-PF since 2000. So that was a war waged against unarmed civilians, including if you look at what happened on the 1st of August, if you look at what happened on the 14th of January 2019, that is a war. Those weapons you saw being fired are the same weapons which were fired in DRC. Those are AK assault rifle. A soldier adopted a kneeling position and fired randomly at fleeing civilians without arms. That is a war. The weapon used was a weapon of war. So it means the government was waging war against its own people. And the people have never retaliated. Now it's high time that the people of Zimbabwe should say no. If it means retaliation, then let retaliation be there. Zima pisa chisoni, zikoma, zikomo, shani. Zino usatsitsi, ndo zvanyorwa apo. Zima pisa chisoni, usatsitsi. Kuti vana veZimbabwe, havana musi wavakambofunga kana one day, kuti ngatidzoserei. Kwanguri kutorwa mudzimba, vachichekwa mutsipa, vachidimburwa mutsipa, vachipfurwa, vachiti dai makaona board yakauzana nyanyeve na Texas. Ndipo munobvuma kuti there was war waged for the past 20 years. Zimbabwe was in a war. Zimbabwe government was in a war with civilians. And civilians never thought of retaliating. Now we are appealing to the civilians. We are appealing to the military. That if you continue doing this, there is no excuse. People have to defend themselves. So Zimbabweans must get ready to defend themselves. Nyaya yekunzi vanhu vanoabdukta vachiurawa, vanhu vachionekwa vakafa zvezve, must stop. If it is an election, let it be an election where people are given choice, freedom to choose. If you lose an election, please go peacefully. If you don't, then Zimbabweans have to find other ways of getting rid of you. This country does not belong to you. It's a country for Zimbabweans. So, chirigai ndirare, ndikungotaura, zviri kuuya kuti kana zvarema zvanetsa, vaZimbabweans vachasvika pakudzosera. Ndopata kusvika. Handiti manzwa. I'm not going to smile, I'm not going to laugh, but after all, enough is enough. Let Zimbabweans fight back. Because hapana nemonopoly to food dzinowanika everywhere in the world. Hapana nemonopoly because food dzirikurira kuZimbabwe dzakabva kuRussia, food dzirikurira kuZimbabwe dzakabva kuChina, and food dzinogona kungobva kuChina nekuRussia food. And more, hapana chinokosha, hapana nemonopoly yekunzi uyatenge food uyanotenga food, uyafanira kudzosera, uyanofanira kuramba achirohwa. Hakuna nemonopoly violence. Vanhu vanogona kuramba vachidzosera, vanhu togona kudzosera. Futi haina basa netraining. Kana kuona vaenda muhondo yeChimurenga, vamwe vachaitrainwa 3 weeks akutonzi enda kuhondo. Hazvina basa izvozviya. Anjonasi akapika akati ndichaona kuti ndoita sei naChamisa. Mamoyo, muri kumudenhera nyuchi. Because anogona iko kwacho kuzani ikokoiko kune vanhu vanoda Chamisa. Vanogona kunomuurayira ikoko. Andoona. Zvekunzi usafa wakapikira munhu kundichakudai. Pavanofuka kuti uchamudai, unotangirwa. Unotangirwa. Ndaiudza mumwe munhu ndikati unoziva kuti futi atanga, papfuti atanga ndiani anouraya mumwe. Ndikatanga kuona usina kundoona ndinoema musoro ndorova. Anoona. Iwo ukatanga kundoona ndisina kukora unoema musoro unorova. Saka hazvina anoti anogona. Nokuti atanga ndiani anouraya. Inini ukandiona nichifamba apo kwandiema unondipfuura ndisina kukuona. Iwewo ndikakuona uchifamba apo ndikakuema ndorova musoro usina kundoona. Saka atanga kuona ndiye anoita sei anohwina. Saka zvana Jonas zvekuti andara kuti ndakuona ndoita sei. Unogona kutadza kusvika musi wacho. You never know. Don't ever promise. Ndaive nemumwe mudhara anzi Kadzvitanga ari officer in charge pachipinde prison. Ndakambomuendera ari ega. Ndikamudinzwa akadzviti chakumamisa. Anga ari superintendent ndandiri least junior. Ndakamuendera achifamba achienda kumba kwake. Ndikati mudhara uyu anojairira steriga ndonomutsa. Mubva ndasvika paari ndikamudinzwa akadzviti iwewe chakumamisa. Hamudzanga kuti chakumamisa hana basa une rengi yako yekuti uri superintendent indiri junior. Chakumamisa chete. Handizani ichaona statue iya yakapfekedzwa MDC t-shirt. Ndopa wachamuka. Saka ndamuudza kadzviti ndichakumamisa mudharai aitanga anorwara bhozi akatrena kuridza artillery kuRomania. Saka anga akafa zvekunzwa anga asinganyatsonzwa anga angozvimba zvekuti anga asingamunzwisa. Aigara akashava ha mudharai zvibuda marute. Saka ndakamuti mudharai ndichakumamisa iwo. Abva ndakaseka kandakamboputika kuseka kundaida kunoudza munhu ndoda kumamisa. Akabva arara aitanga akarara.
Oshayuda. Ah, God. Ah, mano, isho roma azi loko mamisa. Ozo. Ah, nirmu rome. Ah, rani roma mamisa. Ah, mano, isho roma azi loko mamisa. Ozo, yo, jafo, mamisa, to mamisa, na, Oshayuda.
Chai, wala, yudana, yoshu. Chai, kutu, disgazi, Oshayuda. Oshayuda. Muno ishuru maanzi ndoku mamisa. Ano zito mamisa. Bozi you never know kuti ndakabata chi. Ndoku kwadza. Nga muti rambo ishtaro za urtu wana izuzu. Chaku taimira chaku mamisa chete wande. Saka zaka zofa. Aka zofa mdara ye. E, zinu zino siri risa nae. Saka ladies and gentlemen. E, nyika ya Zimbabwe. Aisi nyika ya munu. Arisi brare kuti ndira mining. Nyika ya edu tesi. Wano ya Zimbabwe. Saka nao mashoku anruksira ye. It's time not to allow ourselves to be abused. Anzi kana uchida kuita mbiri ya ginimbi peke za statue ya mbuya na t-shirt ya MDC. Unoita marinai. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. Good night. Good night. Tapeza time ya kawana chikukura. Good night.